Francisco for this much-anticipated Emerald Bowl. For USC head coach Pete Carroll, this season hasn't been the norm. Freshman quarterback Matt Barkley, though, now says he's ready to take the next step. The upset-seeking Boston College Eagles have their own freshman QB. Dave Schinske and this group have overcome so many obstacles. Now there's one last big hurdle, the mighty men of Troy. To the Emerald Bowl, part of Capital One Bowl Week. Tonight, from a rainy AT&T Park, the upstarts from the East take on the power program from the West as Boston College and USC meet up for just the third time in the long-standing rich history of these two programs. Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Tessitore, and I welcome you to a rainy night here in San Francisco. It has been a week of breaking news for USC, all centering around star running back Joe McDight. Here's the latest. He's here with the team, but with the ongoing investigation, he will not be in action tonight against Boston College. Let me say hello to my partner, Rod Gilmore. And, Rod, hey, McKnight's not the only starter out for USC. What effect does that have on them?
Well, it's a talented team with a lot of running backs. I think the bigger impact is up front, where they're not as deep. You take a look along the offensive line, they're missing two key guys. Anthony McCoy, their tight end, who will be a high NFL pick, won't play. Neither will Tyron Smith, the right tackle, a starter. He's out. Both of them missing because of academic issues. This could impact the running game more than the tailback position.
Our Todd Harris is standing by with head coach Pete Carroll for USC. Good evening, Todd.
Hey, good evening to you, Joe and Rod. And Pete, I've got to ask you, what was the final verdict on Joe McKnight playing tonight?
We didn't have enough time to get it all settled, so Joe is not playing tonight.
Okay, now I got to step off the subject a little bit. Your thoughts on Urban Meyer stepping down today?
Well, we just heard about it in pregame, and you know, Urban's been an extraordinary figure in college football, and whatever he's got to do, he's as tough as nails. He'll get back if he can, but if he's not able to, you know, I hope everybody is pulling and praying and sending all the love that we can, and I know he's going to be tough enough to bounce if he can, so we wish him the very best, and particularly to his family.
Thanks for your time, Pete.
Okay.
Thanks, Todd. Of course, we'll have much more on Coach Meyer throughout the evening with the guys in studio. Now, as for Boston College, this is not the team of a few years ago, the high-level stuff with Matt Ryan. This is a group that patchworked somehow their way through overcoming a lot of obstacles. What do they have to do to win tonight?
Yeah, there's no Matt Ryan with this squad, and they don't throw the football like they used to. Montel Harris is a guy who runs, but USC will not let him run the football tonight. They're going to make plays in the passing game, and that means Rich Gannell is going to have a big game at the wide receiver spot. He'll be challenged with man-to-man coverage.
Plenty of questions for the Trojans and Eagles to answer. We'll see how this all plays out in just moments. USC and BC are ready for action when we return to San Francisco. Kickoff is next.
What happened here?
It was after 3. Your blood sugar was low. You should eat them emerald nuts. They'll keep you alert.
Banish the 3 p.m. slump with the natural energy of emerald nuts.
All right, let's lock her down.
To pursue the life you want, you need a financial advocate who knows where you want to go. A Merrill Lynch financial advisor, now with access to the resources of Bank of America, can help you diversify, rebalance, imagine, and believe. Merrill Lynch Wealth Management.
With Rod Gilmore and Todd Harris, I'm Joe Tessitore. USC and Boston College about to kick off in the Emerald Bowl. Two teams that have shown tremendous passion on the field, yet more compassion off of it. And one of the most inspirational stories in all of sports. There he is, Mark Herzlich, the linebacker for BC, courageously battling cancer this year. Herzlich went from potentially an NFL top 10 pick to fighting for his life, now cancer-free, and telling everyone he will return to the field next season. His head coach, BC led by the first year head coach, Frank Spaziani, simply known as Coach Spaz, long acknowledged as one of the most respected defensive coordinators in football before he landed the job last winter. And he has won a bowl game before. He led BC to a win in the 06 Meineke Car Care Bowl as the interim coach. USC won the toss and deferred. BC will receive to open things up. Jacob Harfman to kick for the Trojans.
Yeah, Tess, we had a week of sunshine and cool weather, and rain showed up this evening.
Jeff Smith and Dominic LeGrand back for the Eagles. Pete Carroll, new territory for the head coach. All those years of BCS bowls and the consecutive Pac-10 titles. And now a trip home to the Bay Area to take on BC in the Emerald Bowl. And we are underway here in rainy San Francisco. Here is Smith. Jeff Smith cuts across the 20 and out to the 26. The Boston College offense was led by quarterback Dave Shinsky, a 25-year-old freshman. He was playing minor league baseball for the last 7 years. BC was in a jam last spring, Rod, when their projected starter couldn't keep up with the academics. Shinsky still had college eligibility left, but it's been on the job learning. Strong arm, but inconsistent with the decision making.
Well, he finally made it to a major league ballpark, but he's got a helmet and shoulder pads on.
Yeah, he was double-A material in baseball, but all of a sudden now makes it to the big leagues, a big league stadium as a football player. Coaches say he has come a long way, but still has a long way to go. We got a flag here with motion.
Dead ball, false start, offense, number 81. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Redshirt freshman tight end Chris Pantelia. Look at the BC starting lineup on offense.
That's an offensive line that is big, physical, that they will need. As you see the skill position players there, no real speed burners on that offense, but up front they're tough and physical.
Montel Harris gets the call here as the lone back. Expect to see plenty of that. Somehow stays on his feet and then is taken down for a loss of three. That USC defense, you know, all the guys that went pro last year, and now this is a group that's been maturing as the season's gone along.
Well, fast and athletic up front. You think of Everson Griffin on the outside, a guy who's had a tremendous season. The type of front four that gives Boston College trouble. Malcolm Smith, a very fast linebacker as well. And then on the back end, everybody knows about Taylor Mays at the free safety spot.
Safety Will Harrison came up to make that tackle. Montel Harris. And now Boston College is going to take a timeout early in the game here. Gives us a chance to look at our impact players, brought to you by Theraflu.
Well, offensively for Boston College, it's really about Montel Harris. I mean, he's been a tremendous player for them over the last four ball games, averaging about 32 carries a game. He's the focal point. I think he's going to have a tough time tonight. USC is targeting him, trying to make sure he doesn't get anything done. And one of the guys who will be targeting him is Taylor Mays, three-time All-American, a guy who surprised a lot of people in coming back for his senior season instead of opting for the NFL.
It's interesting. We were at practice the other day, Rod, and sitting there on the sidelines was one of the all-time great safeties, Ronnie Lott.
Yeah.
And we talked to Lott, and we said, hey, give us your quick analysis on Mays. And he said, first and foremost, you're never going to see another physical specimen like him playing that position again.
Yeah, Ronnie said, nobody like him. Nobody with that size and that kind of speed, sub 4'3", at about 6'3", and 235 pounds.
So second and 17 after the timeout. Shinsky on a receiver screen, Gunnell. And Gunnell is wrapped up at the 24-yard line. Just a gain of five. Chris Galippo, a middle linebacker for SC, on top of him.
And this is an athletic USC defense. And Boston College has struggled when they've played against teams like that. Clemson, you think Virginia Tech, both those teams were athletic and fast and able to really shut down Boston College's rushing attack.
So Shinsky will be out of the gun here. On third and 12, the line to make is the 36. Four receivers. Flanked in the backfield by Harris. Four-man rush over the middle, and he's caught for a first down to Gunnell. And Gunnell is just short of midfield. First down, Eagles.
Well, Tess, it's the thing we talked about. Gunnell being a key guy, and he has to beat man-to-man coverage when it's there. You see him as on the inside there, simply running away, a crossing route, running away from T.J. Bryant, who is the nickelback there. And you'll see a lot of crossing routes whenever there is man coverage. It's tough to stay with the receiver when he runs away from you across the field.
25-yard gain to Gunnell, the ACC active leader in catches, receiving yards. He has had a fine career for BC. Now back to the ground with Harris, and he is tripped up for another loss. That time, Malcolm Smith.
Yeah, and you're seeing the formula we talked about. I mean, USC is loading up, and they're going to make sure they take away Harris. And they're going to basically dare Dave Shinsky to beat him. Yeah, and remember, Shinsky, we talked about this guy, was on buses in the minor leagues watching USC play.
He was laughing the other day when I said, hey, what were you doing during last year's bowl season? He said, sitting back with my buddies watching TV. I never would have thought this. But here he is. Facing USC in primetime. To pass on second and 12. They pick up the blitz right up the middle, and it is complete just short of a first down. He was able to get that to Justin Jarvis, a gain of 10.
Well, let's make sure he's in bounds here. 1 foot down is all you need. Looks like that left foot, he had the toes down, not the back heel on the ground, so a good call. But, you know, Tess, getting back to Shinsky, and everybody talks about the football thing being away for 7 years. How about getting back to school?
Absolutely.
7 years of not studying, no homework, and all of a sudden, you got a deal.
He's in the School of Education at the Heights. Now a third and one. Harris trying to get that first down yardage, and he has it. So the Boston College offense moving early here against the Trojans.
And the reason they're moving is because of the passing attack so far. Shinsky has completed a couple of big passes, a big third down, and then on second down, a second and long, he converted that to set up a short third down situation. And Pete Carroll's defense struggled the second half of the season.
And now two backs in for the Eagles. Jeff Smith, who's a real speed burner, comes in as they go wildcat. And Shinsky splits out to the near side. Harris, the direct snap. Fumbles the ball and then falls on it. It has been raining for a good hour and a half here in San Francisco. Just starting to taper off here as the game moves forward.
That's the thing you worry about when you have somebody step in and take a snap like that. Wet ball as he prepared to handle it. That's that wildcat. Can we just get an agreement here? They call this the bazooka.
The BC version of it is referred to as the bazooka.
Let's just agree and stipulate that when you line up like that, that's the wildcat.
It needs the universal name of wildcat, you say.
You don't give a new name to the shotgun because everybody runs
that's
it, right?
That's a good point. So that's a loss of four. Shinsky to pass now. Going deep, looking for Jarvis again, and off the fingertips. He went up for it in coverage against Sharice Wright and couldn't come down with it.
And Sharice Wright was in great position. And Wright is a guy who hasn't played all season. This is his first ball game back after sitting out this year, academic issues. And he's been reinstated and has been practicing the last couple weeks, stepped in because Josh Pinkert had an ACL, his third knee injury, and Wright got the start.
All right, it's a very fluid athlete. That's good timing for him, for the Trojans to have him back in action. James McCluskey flanking Shinsky now in the shotgun here on third and 14. Pressure up the middle, and Shinsky just throws it in direction of Jarvis. It goes incomplete. The pressure came from Jarrell Casey, a big sophomore defensive tackle. So Frank Spaziani saw his offense cross midfield and then unable to pick up the first down there. So instead, Ryan Quigley will come on to punt for BC. Very dangerous Damian Williams settling in at the 10, but just a directional punt here that takes a BC roll just inside the 10. We are underway here in San Fran, BC and USC.
An ordinary man in a race against time.
Just cooked a hard ride north on Alvarado.
He has the information.
Somebody's one step ahead of us. How's that possible?
Where's he going?
He has the tools.
Where's he heading?
But most of all, he has AT&T, the nation's fastest 3G network. Get 50% off all BlackBerry smartphones after mail-in rebate. Only from AT&T.
Hi, is Denise working?
Yeah, she's in the back. Can I take your order?
I'm just a little bit more comfortable ordering with Denise.
Bye.
Hey, hi, you remember me? I came by yesterday, gave me that five-layer burrito, that new one for
89 cents.
Is that cool? Is that still cool?
It's an inside deal for everyone. Layers of seasoned beef, cheddar cheese, and a hidden layer of nacho cheese sauce. It's Taco Bell's new beefy five-layer burrito for just 89 cents. Why pay more?
It's a revolution in pain relief.
The new Icy Hot Medicated Roll. Take what you need for shoulders, backs, joints, even arthritis. Medicated Relief gets icy to dull pain, hot to relax it away. The new Icy Hot Medicated Roll.
With the roll, pain's under control.
Yeah, thanks, man. It's pretty...
Hey, Sonny, toss me a...
Dad, you okay?
You can't always be smooth, but your beer should be. Smooth brewed for that smooth Keystone taste. Keystone Light is always smooth, even when you're not.
Grandpa, I'm sorry.
Diamond Foods is pleased to welcome you to the 8th annual Emerald Bowl. As a San Francisco-based food company, we would like to highlight the Glide Foundation, a community organization we are proud to support.
Thank you, Linda. We need partnerships like yours to support all of Glide's programs, which give help and hope to all people.
Happy holidays from all of us at Diamond Foods and Glide.
Matt Barkley, the first USC true freshman ever start the season at quarterback for the Trojans. And what a start it was. Big win at Ohio State in week two. But the back half of the season, it got to him. Allen Bradford. Bradford still pushing forward out to the 17-yard line. And there is the 19-year-old, 6'2", 230-pounder. He looks and talks like the part, Rod.
Yeah, yeah. And, you know, it's fascinating talking to him, watching him this week. He said he hit the wall midway through the season, that all the stuff around college football drained him.
Past few weeks, though, no classes, just practice. Chance to get back mentally, he said. And completes his first pass of the night for a first down. That to Rojo, Ronald Johnson. A look at the starting lineup for the Trojans.
Skill players, a lot of focus on the backfield with Allen Bradford getting the start for McKnight. And then on the outside, Damian Williams, likely his last game for USC before he heads to the NFL. Charles Brown, the left tackle, the top offensive lineman in the Pac-10 this season, as voted by his peers.
The pass again, Williams, and that's a good defensive play to come up and make the stick by DeLeon Gauze, because Williams is so dangerous in the open field.
And Boston College defense up front, can they hold up inside? Denise Scafay, can he do well inside against that big offensive line? That's a big question up front for them. And the linebackers, good group. And how about the freshman Luke Kuechly, leading the team in tackles, outstanding season. On the back end, Wes Davis and Marcellus Bowman, strong safety, big hitter.
Second and four now for the Trojans. Bradford straight up the middle and just over that mark to make for a first down.
Well, when you take McKnight out, you lose shiftiness. You lose a little bit of the big play ability from the line of scrimmage. But with Bradford, you gain strength, power, toughness, probably a little better inside running, and a guy you can probably give it to a lot more than you can give it to McKnight.
McKnight's a buck 90. Bradford goes 235 pounds. It's the call again. This time, that front of BC able to penetrate the line and get to Bradford. Brad Newman and Demeek Scafay in on the stop. Let's take a look at tonight's impact players, brought to you by Theraflu.
It's a running back spot. Now, Bradford's a guy who's really tough, came to USC as a defensive player, and he has not lost that mentality as a running back. You'll see him try and run over guys on the defensive side. Luke Kuechly, an outstanding freshman. Just wait until he figures out how to play linebacker. He was a high school safety.
Barkley, plenty of time, and completes it to Johnson again. Johnson is right on that line to make for a first down. Let's check in with Todd Harris.
Well, Joe, one of the unique things about the Emerald Bowl here is both teams are on the same side of the field, which is beneficial right now for Pete Carroll, because he has gone over the 10 yards to the Boston College bench twice, asking them to take off their headsets. The reason? The USC headsets are not working, so they're unable to communicate with their coaches up above. So Pete has gone over twice, asked Coach Frank Spaziani, do you got anything up there? And he said, yeah, we've got ours fine. He said, would you guys mind taking off? I hate to do it to you, but we got nothing.
Well, it's been a rainy night. You got a unique configuration with the sidelines to begin with, and now the headset issue as well for the coaches. Bradford stacked up right away by McLaughlin.
Tess, you mentioned that headset situation. You have two benches on the same side. They're separated by, what, about 10 yards in the middle. USC is to our left, Boston College to our right. You take a look over here. There you'll find USC. Here you'll find Boston College. That's how they're separated. Now, they've made some adjustments. If a coach has to run on the field to make a timeout or challenge, they'll let him do it because of this unique configuration.
And we'll talk about substitutions as well when teams are near their goal line. Pressure on Barkley, but he gets it to his fullback, Havili. And Havili with blockers in front. Here he goes. Stanley Havili. Touchdown, USC. 53 yards. Barkley able to find his fullback. Stanley Havili, they say he's a weapon that you can use him any which way and put him anywhere. You just got a taste of it. Ogden, the extra point, up and good. So Barkley and company, after their struggles in the back half of the season, off to a good start here in the Emerald Bowl.
Grandma's favorite movie is The Dark Knight?
Yeah, she loves the Batman voice.
You wanted me, here I am.
She is good.
So is Bobby.
You're garbage, Joker. Where's Harvey Dent? Let her go!
If they're not careful, they could...
Where is he?
Where is he?
Where is he?
Know your limits, Master Wayne.
For a great movie night, make it pop.
It's happening across the country, across our lineup. Nissan's A to Z year-end sales event, celebrating award-winning design, automobile of the year, best buys, and quality from A to Z. Now get $500 additional bonus cash on Altima and Maxima, plus $199 a month on the new Altima, or 0% financing on Maxima. Event ends January 4th.
Hey, Ham, what do you think the fine is for streaking?
Oh, I don't know, like $300-$400?
Why?
Go State! Sorry!
The more you save on insurance, the more you'll have football. Drivers who switched to Allstate saved an average of $396 a year. Are you in good hands?
Is it done yet?
No.
Would you like to go for a ride in that bike?
Okay.
Whoa, yeah. You see, the terms require you keep the bike in this predetermined space. If you want to take the bike out, I'm going to have to charge you a penalty.
I can't really ride in this little space.
Well, you can't ride very far.
Even kids know an offer shouldn't come with ridiculous conditions. Why don't banks? We're Ally, a new bank whose no-penalty CD lets you withdraw all your money and bring it anywhere without a fee. It's just the right thing to do.
ESPN College Football, the Emerald Bowl, is brought to you by Emerald Nuts. Stay sharp at 3 p.m. with natural energy from Emerald Nuts. Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy. And Allstate, proud sponsor of college football and the Allstate Sugar Bowl. Are you in good hands?
That was Union Square in downtown San Francisco earlier today, where they had a pep rally, and you saw Coach Carroll and Coach Spaz getting the fans stoked for tonight's Emerald Bowl. Matt Barkley 4-for-4. That touchdown pass to Stanley Havili to open up the scoring for Carroll and company.
That's great for the stats for the quarterback when you're running back and make a play like that.
Yeah, when your fullback just bowling balls his way down the field. 7-zip. Arfman kicking off again to Smith and LeGrand. And here is Smith from the two. Good return out to the 31.
Hey, Tess, let's go back to the touchdown play. Here's Savili just in that fullback spot. He's just a hot receiver. He's going to see some pressure to the outside. He's going to slip by it, and he's the hot receiver looking for the pass. There it is. A couple of missed tackles by Boston College. Keekly misses one. Morris McLaughlin misses another. Savili, outstanding runner, was a tailback in high school, cruises his way into the end zone.
Junior from Salt Lake City. Everybody talked about not having Joe McKnight. Well, with Allen Bradford and Stanley Havili, they have plenty of weaponry in that backfield. Play action now. Shinsky over the middle and threw it behind the intended receiver. He was trying to get it to Rich Gannell. Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN tomorrow night. Kentucky's going to take on C.J. Spiller and the Clemson Tigers in the Gaylord Hotel Music City Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN. Also on ESPN360.com tomorrow night, 8:30 Eastern. C.J. Spiller, what a season he had, Rob.
Oh, amazing.
Listen, I know that there were outstanding players and many of them for the Heisman this year, but was there a more exciting player than C.J. Spiller?
He should have been in New York.
I agree with that.
Needed to be in New York along with the other finalists.
So Shinsky on second down will sprint to the far side and able to complete it. Let's see if he stayed in bounds, and yes, he did. Justin Jarvis, nice footwork on the far sideline there. A 19-yard reception from Shinsky.
Yeah, see Taylor Mays coming over at the end with the hit. Takes a bad angle on the play and isn't quite where he needs to be. Looks like that foot was down. Looks like that right foot, left foot down. Yep, that's a good catch. That's in. And Taylor Mays coming over a little late, bad angle. He's sometimes been criticized for not taking the proper angle on his approach to the player or the ball. So one knock against him, not many.
Harris now is trying to power his way across midfield and does so to the USC 49. Malcolm Smith and Christian Tupou getting to Harris.
You think about this USC defense and you go, well, how do you attack them? You look at what happened this season. Oregon really blitzed them with a lot of quarterback runs. You know, you got Masoli at the quarterback spot, did a great job. Stanford used some quarterback runs with Andrew Luck, but primarily they pounded the defensive ends with that off-tackle power run. So Boston College is looking at those two game plans thinking maybe some of that will work for us against this defense.
Well, they're a little closer to being more like Stanford. It's a loose ball kicked around, finally picked up by Harris, but all the way back at the 40-yard line. Kennard was able to track him down. That is a loss of 11 yards.
Yeah, and Boston College has had more trouble dealing with the wet football than USC. Hey, a low snap.
He wasn't ready for it, and it hit him right in his
right
shin.
Right in his shin. That's a ground ball. Yeah, even a pitcher expecting it can handle that, but Shinsky not prepared for that one.
And the starting center on Boston College, Matt Tennant, he's a senior and expected to be one of the top centers in the NFL draft. He's had a very good career.
And this is a tough deal, you know, for a freshman quarterback, third and forever.
Third and 19. Over the middle, off the fingertips of his tight end, Chris Pantelli. Michael Morgan had coverage. So that bad snap backs up BC and unable to convert.
Boston College is not an offense that can continuously convert third and long. They have to shorten their schedule. They have to stay on schedule to have third and four, third and five. They can't play third and 10, third and 19.
Wiggly's punt now, driving back Damian Williams, who calls for the fair catch at about the 17-yard line. 43-yard punt by Quigley. Matt Barkley back on the field when we return to San Francisco.
Capital One Bowl Week continues through January 2nd.
It's happening across the country. Across our lineup, Nissan's A to Z year-end sales event celebrating award-winning design, Automobile of the Year, Best Buys, and quality from A to Z.
Now get $500 additional bonus cash on Altima and Maxima, plus $199 a month on the new Altima, or 0% financing on Maxima. Event ends January 4th.
You made the front page.
Probably a name and no picture.
Critics everywhere agree. Sherlock Holmes is explosive. Spectacular.
There isn't any time to waste that.
One of the best films of the year.
Now we have a firm grasp of the obvious. Most engaging.
Sherlock Holmes.
Madam, beneath this pillow lies the key to my release.
Rated PG-13. Now playing.
A Monday night battle from the black and blue division, Coach.
It's time to pound a rock.
Intense NFC North rivals meet for a Monday night slugfest.
Brett Favre and the Vikings are fighting for prime playoff position.
But Jay Cutler and the Bears will be on the prowl for an upset.
Can the division champs get back on track, or will Chicago bear down for a Windy City win?
ESPN Monday Night Football, Vikings Bears at 8:30.
Oh, in this world that's ever changing, I just wanna be true. I don't wanna be the same as everybody. What do I
it's
do?
It's easy to switch from a white tee to a white bee. Tired of the same thing, come follow me. Wait till you see skinny.com. Choose your device on the screen. iPod, laptop, Mac or PC. Do you got an Xbox or a PS3? A Nintendo Wii or MP3? They got it all, whatever you need. Booster, sidekick, Bluetooth headset, digital camera, camcorders, even modem and router decks. Talk about a new wave, and this is the next. Personalize or check their designs. Military, urban, fashion, music, even butterfly. Entertainment, sports, to skin it for a cause. Rise, politician, or get your religion on. So everybody do you and listen to this song. Get on the internet, go to skinny.com.
SKINIT.com.
Beautiful look at the Bay Bridge. We're in San Francisco, USC up 7-0. From coast to coast, you can now get the latest news on the teams you care about most. The power of ESPN covering the Boston, Chicago, Dallas, and now the Los Angeles sports scenes on ESPNBoston.com. You can see what Kevin Garnett is saying about his injured head. And on ESPNLosAngeles.com, Phil Jackson and his reaction to the fans' reaction at the Staples Center last night. News, opinions, special sports center just for your city. The inside info you're accustomed to now with local flavor. ESPNLosAngeles.com, ESPNChicago.com, and ESPNBoston.com. Matt Barkley back to action here. Bradford trying to break a tackle but unable to do so as Mike McLaughlin held on to that foot. Gain of 3.
You know, I got ESPNLosAngeles.com on up right now.
Well, that was the place you wanted to be for all this Joe McKnight soap opera that happened this week, right?
I've been rolling it around on my phone all week.
Matt Barkley off to a good start tonight. A touchdown pass on the opening series. You know, it was a rocky road that back half of the season, Rob.
Huh, no kidding. He talked about being drained from having all the media commitments.
Gets it quickly out to Ronald Johnson, and Gaws right there to make a strong play. And this is a player that BC needs to have a good game tonight. DeLeon Gaws, the junior quarterback, a loss of 2.
Well, the more they're able to put USC in second and long and third and long, the better off they are, because Matt Barkley struggled the second half of the season. And as I was saying, he complained that, yeah, it was an issue for him to deal with the media requests and have to do his schooling. And sometimes he got so worked up he went home to have his folks do his laundry and spend a little time at home.
There's nothing wrong with that. Mom doing the laundry when you're a freshman in college. Able to connect here. That's out to the 28-yard line. A gain of 9. David Osberry. He's a big target, Osberry.
Watching Barkley in practice this week, didn't you get the impression that he looked pretty sharp and a lot more relaxed?
Absolutely. He made the comment of saying, you know, I know for a fact that I've matured and I've progressed, but the record doesn't show it. The results that we've seen on the field don't necessarily show it. I think having the past few weeks without classes a chance to just focus in on one opponent has served Matt Barkley well.
That's a big game for him tonight. Not so much for tonight, but for next year, to start getting that confidence back that he had at the beginning of the season.
First down to pass again. A little bit of pressure. He gets away from it and then throws it to Havili. But right there is Luke Kuechly. Pressure came from Alex Albright.
Well, and you think about Barkley and next year for USC, and they may lose their top running back. They may lose their top wide receiver. And you expect Barkley to make a big leap from his freshman year to his sophomore year and to handle more of the offense and to be more responsible for producing points for the offense next season.
Those in the know around the program, the name I'm hearing that he reminds him of is Carson Palmer.
Yep.
In terms of what he's capable of in the stages of progression. Second and 8 now. That is incomplete. He was trying to get it to Damian Williams. Mike Morrissey is right on top of the speeder receiver.
Good job by Boston College defensively. You know, they're not rushing a lot of guys. They don't get sacks. They only have 17 this season, so they're dropping a lot of guys in coverage, trying to mix their coverage up, run a couple stunts up front, but they're not a blitzing team. They just can't get it done that way.
So after his first incompletion of the game, Barkley now facing 3rd and 8 against this Eagles defense. 3-step drop, has it complete. Out to the 41-yard line to Damian Williams, a gain of 11. Talk this week, Rod, of Damian Williams perhaps foregoing his last year of eligibility and heading off to the NFL.
Yeah, the word is that he is listed as one of the top 10 receivers, not in the top 5. Question about his flat-out speed. No question about his versatility, his hands, his quickness. And he seems to be leaning towards leaving. That's the word we've been hearing all week.
Fresh set of downs now. C.J. Gable in as the featured back. And he gets the ball here. Gable try to utilize that speed to the outside. He was quickly tracked down by Mike Morrissey and Albright.
Now, I thought it was interesting you were chatting with Pete Carroll yesterday about motivation for this ball game, and after seeing them in practice this week, that there was little concern about that.
They seem very spirited.
Yeah, I agree.
And for a lot of these players, Barkley obviously a freshman, and many of the players on defense that were backups, the guys now playing in the NFL, hey, this is a great experience for them. They're starting in a bowl game. It's something special to them. Coming to the end of the first quarter here, as Barkley will just let the clock run down. Good start for the freshman quarterback. Had the touchdown pass as the Trojans moving again. More to come from San Francisco. Stay with us.
Away from your TV for Capital One Bowl Week, watch it live online at ESPN360.com.
It's happening across the country, across our lineup. Nissan's A to Z year-end sales event, celebrating award-winning design, automobile of the year, best buys, and quality from A to Z. Now get $500 additional bonus cash on Altima and Maxima, plus $199 a month on the new Altima, or 0% financing on Maxima. Event ends January 4th.
S stands for straightforward, as in upfront, honest, total transparency. Straightforward is the way TD Ameritrade does business. Simple, fair pricing, no hidden account fees, no shenanigans. Just good value, real help, smart people who are easy to work with. That's what TD Ameritrade stands for. What does your investment firm stand for?
It's time for fresh thinking. It's time for TD Ameritrade.
If you ever make international calls, only Vonage gives you unlimited calling in the U.S. and around the world for just $24.99. Introducing Vonage World. Call 877-4-VONAGE today. Then call India, all of India, or Brazil, all of Brazil. In fact, call all corners of over 60 countries free. And now, sign up by December 31st and get 1 month free. Don't wait. Call 877-4-VONAGE or go to Vonage.com and start saving.
If you've had a heart attack caused by a completely blocked artery, another heart attack could be lurking, waiting to strike. A heart attack caused by a clot, one that could be fatal. But Plavix helps save lives. Plavix, taken with other heart medicines, goes beyond what other heart medicines do alone to provide greater protection against heart attack or stroke and even death by helping to keep blood platelets from sticking together and forming clots. Ask your doctor about Plavix, protection that helps save lives. People with stomach ulcers or other conditions that cause bleeding should not use Plavix. Taking Plavix alone or with some other medicines, including aspirin, may increase bleeding risk, so tell your doctor when planning surgery. Certain genetic factors in some medicines, such as Prilosec, may affect how Plavix works. Tell your doctor all the medicines you take, including aspirin, especially if you've had a stroke. If fever, unexplained weakness, or confusion develops, tell your doctor promptly. These may be signs of TTP, a rare but potentially life-threatening condition reported sometimes less than 2 weeks after starting Plavix. Other rare but serious side effects may occur.
Introducing the new great-tasting EAS Myoplex Nutrition Shake with 25 grams of protein, reformulated to help more athletes refuel, build lean muscle, and give.
Emerald Bowl, part of Capital One Bowl Week. We're in beautiful San Francisco, AT&T Park, home to the Major League Baseball San Francisco Giants, where they have shoehorned in this football field into this magnificent baseball stadium. USC on top of BC 7-0. Barkley gets it up quickly to Williams. And Damian Williams taken down after a gain of four by Luke Kuechly, freshman linebacker.
Part of the game plan for USC is to really take advantage of their speed advantage, their quickness advantage, and Damian Williams is part of that. You know, get him the ball in space, quick screen, you know, reverses, get him the ball, let him make the same kind of moves from the line of scrimmage that he does on punt returns.
First team Pac-10 as a wide receiver and a punt returner for Pete Carroll. Junior receiver from Arkansas, transferred from Arkansas. Third and four. Time and able to complete it to Rojo crossing midfield. And Ronald Johnson with a gain of nine. Good start tonight for Matt Barkley.
Tess, that was a great job by Barkley. Boston College showed him a two deep coverage right before the snap and then switched the coverage to show man, and Barkley recognized it and saw the mistake to the outside and found his receiver. And that's something you don't typically find with young quarterbacks, but he recognized it and made a nice adjustment.
10 of 11 so far tonight against this BC defense is Barkley. Exactly how he wanted things to go after what was a bit of a struggle down the stretch of this season. Airing it out now. Williams. Damian Williams. Inside the 10, out at the 6. 38-yard reception by Williams.
Well, we talked about the speed difference, and there's a bad matchup there as he's with Wes Davis, but I don't think he was in bounds.
I know that the one foot was down, but as he caught the ball, it looked like the right foot then stepped out.
I don't think he was in bounds with that.
And USC tried to do the smart thing and hurry up and get a playoff.
The previous play is under review.
So we will take a break. As they sort things out here, the ruling on the field, of course, was a completed pass to Damian Williams.
So you know what that means. That means you got to have indisputable video evidence to overturn the call. You have to assume that the call on the field is correct. Here you see the bad matchup. And it looks to me like that ball was caught when the right foot came down, not when he has the left foot down. Left foot there, no ball. Now right foot down, out of bounds. That's not a catch.
Bill Jordan's the replay official tonight. He's Mountain West crew. And I think he stabbed that left foot but did not have possession until the right foot then went out of bounds.
Exactly. The ball was still on its way down when the left foot was in bounds. But he didn't have it. But you can see USC trying to get the matchups and use their speed advantage as Williams was on the free safety Wes Davis and just ran by him. Now, this play may not stand, but they will come back to it because that's
after
a matchup.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands.
Wow.
Whoa.
Hard to believe that one.
Whoa.
Remember, and really, you got to stress this. It is the ruling on the field that has to be assumed correct.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then they have to have the indisputable video evidence.
All right, left foot down. And it looks like the ball was still in the air. I can only surmise that they felt they could not determine whether the ball was actually in his hands or not from that angle from the backside. That's the only possible explanation.
So first and goal, USC. Bradford unable to turn that corner. He was taken down by McLaughlin and Albright. Pete Carroll's offense getting a break there on the long reception to Damian Williams. Look at what they've done in the red zone, Rod.
Yeah, they've not been good this year. Touchdown percentage, 38% on the year, USC, when they're in the red zone, inside the 20 trying to score.
12th play of this drive. Play action, Barkley rolling out to the near side. Touchdown, and once again, finding the fullback, Havili. Touchdown pass, Barkley to Havili. Havili did it all on his own the first time they hooked up to make it 7-0. This was nice work by Barkley in the red zone.
Yeah, and just a mistake by the linebackers of Boston College. Third receiver to the inside belongs to the linebackers, and they just didn't see Havili. They let him go. He came from the far side.
Jordan Congdon tacks on the extra point. Now let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio. RD.
All right, Joe, this is a college football bowl update presented by Flomax. Urban Meyer stepping down as head coach of the Florida Gators after a glorious 5 years in which he led Florida to two SEC and two national championships. Urban's final game as head coach of the Gators will be in the All-State Sugar Bowl New Year's night against Cincinnati. Meyer saying that he wanted to refocus on his health, his family, and get his priorities with his faith in order as well as the sole reason. We'll have much more on this story throughout the night on ESPN.
They're running the men's room marathon.
With lots of guys going over and over.
And here's the dash to the men's room with lots of guys going urgently.
And then there's the night game.
Waking up to go.
These guys should be in a race to see their doctors.
Right. Those could be urinary symptoms due to BPH, an enlarged prostate.
But for many guys, prescription Flomax reduces their urinary symptoms due to BPH in 1 week.
Only your doctor can tell if you have BPH, not a more serious condition like prostate cancer.
When taking Flomax, avoid driving or hazardous tasks until you know how Flomax will affect you, as a sudden drop in blood pressure may occur, rarely resulting in fainting.
Tell your doctor about all medications you take. If considering cataract surgery, tell your eye surgeon you've taken Flomax.
Common side effects are runny nose, dizziness, and decrease in semen.
Ask your doctor if Flomax is right for you.
Call 877-4-FLOMAX to see if you qualify for up to $40 off new or refill prescriptions.
For many men, Flomax can make a difference in 1 week.
What are you looking for?
A hairbrush for a Rapunzel Barbie doll.
Oh.
Holiday savings are still happening at Walmart. Starting this Saturday, come to Walmart's Garden Center and get 50% off Christmas items. Save money, live better. Walmart.
It seems no matter what channel you're watching, everyone's talking about the Snuggie, the ultra-soft blanket that has sleeves. But the one question we keep getting is,
when are you going to make one that looks a little more stylish for me?
The answer is, we just did. Introducing the new Snuggie Designer Series, a thicker, more luxurious fleece, now in gorgeous fashion prints and colors, like our cozy and warm leopard fleece that looks as good as it feels. There's also our cute and cuddly zebra print to keep you nice and toasty. With Snuggie, you can use your remote, enjoy a snack, talk on the phone, do what you need to, all while wrapped in total warmth and comfort for only $19.95. You'll also receive our compact press and open book light, a $15 value free. But call right now and we'll give you a second Snuggie and book light free. Just pay processing and handling. Yes, you get it all for only $19.95.
Call 1-800-439-0490 or go online at designersnuggie.com.
Fullback Stanley Havili with a couple of touchdowns tonight as USC leads Boston College 14-0 here in the Emerald Bowl. Monday night, we got an NFC North battle at Soldier Field. Brett Favre, Adrian Peterson, and the Vikings roll into Chicago to take on the Bears. Monday Night Football, 8:30 Eastern. Coverage begins with Monday Night Countdown, served by Applebee's at 7 Eastern. The beautiful bay. That's Rod Gilmore's way home right there over to Alameda.
Yeah, hopefully there won't be much traffic this evening after the ball game.
Happy holidays to everybody. Hope you're enjoying the holiday weekend. Joe Tessitore, Rod Gilmore, Todd Harris with you here. So that big long pass that was ruled in bounds sets up the second touchdown of the night for the Trojans, and now the squid kick recovered by Keekly.
Let's go back to that touchdown. Here's Havili over here. He's one of two receivers. Now, normally in man coverage, you have a couple guys playing in and out. Well, they don't, or they lose him. He goes across the formation, and he's unaccounted for because he goes across the formation. He's the third guy to the left side of the formation now, and someone has to be responsible for the third guy. And Boston College blew it. Somebody blew the assignment.
No McKnight. Joe McKnight not suited up tonight. But the fullback Stanley Havili playing a big role in the passing game. And now that bazooka offense, Montel Harris. And here goes Montel Harris. A good run on the direct snap. Out to the 48. A gain of 16.
How about we agree? I thought we agreed.
The Wildcat bazooka.
There's no
offensive
bazooka.
Coordinator Gary Tranquil says it's bazooka. It's the game we're covering.
Okay, now when we see teams across the country line up in the shotgun and we don't call it the shotgun, then we'll change and let everybody
this
name
this formation.
This is
going to be a movement by you.
Absolutely. It's a wildcat. Just like the shotgun.
Well, they're sticking with it again. Shinsky now. It worked so well earlier this season against NC State. And now right up the middle goes Harris. Good hard running to the 41. Another first down for BC.
If you think back to the last half of the season for USC, they were terrible against the run. Oregon, Stanford pounded them inside. They got pushed off. Look inside. You see number 44, Christian Tapu, having a problem inside. They just got a good push inside, and that happened the last half of the season against strong offensive lines.
Taylor Mays coming off the field, a little banged up there. An All-American safety. Of course, he can bring a lot to defend against the running game, but you talk about what happened in the back half of the season. Oregon went for 391 rushing yards against this SC defense. Mays was in on that last tackle, and now he's off the field. Again, they go with Harris, and again, it works right up the middle. Montel Harris inside the 30 to the 27.
Yeah, and Tess, as you talk to coaches in and around the Pac-10 and talk about the USC defense, the word was very fast, very athletic, but not as physical at the point of attack as they have been in the past. And you can see it here. The offensive line, Boston College, able to push guys out of the way and some missed tackles down the field for USC. That's a product of an inexperienced young defense. 8 new starters this season for them.
McCluskey now, the lone back here on first down, and he gets the call. And bowls his way to the 24. A gain of 3 for James McCluskey.
Yeah, talking to Coach Spaz this week, we talked about the Oregon game and the Stanford game, and he said, I don't have Jeremiah Masoli, and I don't have Toby Gerhardt. You know, he said, so I'm not sure I can run those game plans exactly. He has Montel Harris, but he's not 235 pounds like Toby Gerhardt.
Klusky stays in on 2nd and 7. Complete inside the 10 to Justin Jarvis. A good look from Dave Shinsky.
He did a nice job. He caught USC in a double coverage to the outside, a cover 2, one guy short, one guy deep behind him, and he threaded the needle in between them. Looks out to his left, and he just goes beyond the first guy and in front of the second guy. And the second guy is Drew McAllister, who's in for Taylor Mays.
So BC quick to come down with the power running game, and then they get Jarvis involved. Now first and goal. Harris right up the middle. Touchdown. That was a statement drive. 14 zip. They responded that they're here tonight.
And they responded with a physical drive, running right at USC, much like we saw teams do the second half of the season. And they'll take a look at this.
Watch his knee here, Rod.
Yeah,
that's going to be close.
Right knee.
Still up.
Yeah, but the question is, where is the ball? Did it break the plane? And then once again, you need to assume that the call on the field is correct, and you need indisputable video evidence to the contrary to overturn that call.
Watch the right knee. Still up because he stretches back and kicks out. That's going to be a tough one to overturn.
Yeah, because it's not substituting judgment. You can't say, well, I think he's in. You have to say, I see something that's clear that he didn't get in. And so we need to see clearly that his knee is down and the ball does not break the plane. Those are the two things you're looking for, and I can't see it from this angle.
You know, you bring up such a good point. I know you've stressed it numerous times. You see how he kicks out his right leg rather than diving with the knee straight down? I think that's what's going to get them the touchdown upheld here. But the point, if you cannot have judgment when you're looking as the replay official, you have to assume that the call on the field stands. Thus why moments earlier in this game, the long 53-yard pass to Damian Williams also stood as to whether he was inbounds or out of bounds, because the camera angle, his back was to the camera. It looked as if it shouldn't have stood up. That
right.
Set up the last touchdown. Let's get the call here.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Score a touchdown.
14th rushing touchdown for Montel Harris. This is a workhorse sophomore running back for BC.
He's talented. The first few times I watched him on tape, I thought, okay, he's all right. You know, he's kind of a guy, maybe just a guy. And the more you watch him, the more you go, hey, he's talented. He's carrying guys. He can make some moves. He's a lot better football player than you think. The more you watch him, the more you like him.
Off the post. Opanovicius unable to connect after what was such a sensational year of kicking for him. So Harris gets the Eagles on the board, but the missed extra point, they're down by 8.
Slump with the natural energy of Emerald Nuts.
Lady, get out!
This is no time to play. I'm picking a photo for my Capital One credit card. Old man Sutter? Why would I put his picture on my card? Nice drawing, but this photo's cuter.
Personalize your card by uploading your own photo at CapitalOne.com.
Lady, what's in your wallet?
911, what's your emergency?
When the flu hits you hard, hit right back with Theraflu. Nothing fights your worst flu symptoms with more power. Theraflu, good to be back.
They told me I was going to get a vest.
Don't worry about the vest, it'll be fine.
See what was hiding.
This is an amazing find.
Inside the must-see movie of the year.
Oh my God.
District 9, own it now on Blu-ray. The best way to watch movies at home ever.
George, my team deserves a race.
You've only been here a week.
Not even.
ESPN College Football, the Emerald Bowl, is brought to you by Emerald Nuts. Stay sharp at 3 p.m. with natural energy from Emerald Nuts. Capital One, what's in your wallet? And Prevacid 24 Hour, when you've had it with heartburn.
That's the Clyde Memorial Church on Christmas morning. Players from both USC and Boston College got together to help serve the public. Over 5,000 meals were prepared, all the trimmings by 850 volunteers. Matt Barkley from USC was there, BC players. They had 120-pound turkeys to help out with those in need in this holiday weekend.
USC wanted to send all their players, but because of space, they had to limit it to 15 players from each team.
Both schools should be very proud of the way these young men represented themselves during this bowl week. And there's a young man who has turned into something special for Boston College, running back Montel Harris, whose hard running has put the Eagles on the board. Short kick now, hauled in at the 30, fair caught there. Let's check in with Todd Harris. Todd?
Well, Joe, moments ago, the first man to greet Steve Aponovicius was head coach Frank Sbaziani. He said, hey, what's the deal? The snap was good, right? The hold was good, right? What happened? He said, my foot slipped. He said, your foot slipped? Don't worry about it. Typical Spaz.
You know, that just goes to show you. He's a guy that everybody was pleased for when he got the job at Boston College. A guy who it looked like for a while would never get a shot to be a head coach.
So Matt Barkley in the Trojans offense back to business. And Havili, who's had a huge first half, two touchdowns and now this 10-yard reception.
Havili hasn't been covered yet out of the backfield. They've used him in the fullback position. They put him as a second tight end, kind of a wing back position. And he's been open on every single occasion they've tried to get him the football.
Four catches for 70 yards and a couple of touchdowns for Havili. Bradford now. Allen Bradford, good first cross midfield to the BC 45-yard line, a gain of 15. Finally taken down by Marcellus Bowman.
And they just gashed them that time as they pulled Jeff Byers, the left guard. Watch him come around and hit this block coming downhill big time. That's Byers, 53. Man, what a big block that was.
First team all Pac-10 offensive lineman. Dealt with so many injuries in his career. He's given a 6-year of eligibility after missing 2 years with injuries. And now the fullback on a carry right up the middle, Havili. And this time he finds some traffic as they gang tackle him, but forward progress has him marked at about the 43-yard line. The freshman Luke Kuechly was the first to get to him.
As we watched Kuechly in practice this week, He was consistently concerned about getting caught up inside in traffic and not getting back to make plays when they ran the ball inside, because he is so aggressive, so fast with it. He'll read quickly and head where he thinks the ball is going and then have to fight to get back inside. He's an instinctive player, almost 12 tackles a game.
Yeah, and since the NCAA started tracking tackles, no freshman has ever averaged more tackles per game than Luke Kuechly.
Delay of game, offense, number 7, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
So that'll back up the Trojans a bit. Luke Kuechly, St. Xavier High School in Cincinnati. That pipeline continues for BC recruits.
Young man has had a great season, 142 tackles, second in the country. Was recruited by so many schools, said no to Duke, Virginia, Stanford, wanted to go to Boston College, felt it was the perfect fit.
All ACC first team selection. Of course, the loss of Mark Herzlick hurt this defense, but Kuechly, such a pleasant surprise.
Prior to the snap, timeout, USC. First charge, timeout of the half.
There is Mark Herzlick. We're going to take a break on that timeout. When we come back, our Todd Harris will catch up with the star linebacker.
Capital One Bowl Week continues through January 2nd.
Just nuts.
So what do you think?
I think I'll go with the preferred package.
Good choice.
Only Meineke gives you options on complete car care, and we'll help you choose what's right for you, your car, and your budget. At Meineke, you're always the driver.
A Monday night battle from the black and blue division, Coach. It's time to pound a rock.
Brett Favre and the Vikings fight for prime playoff position against the Bears. ESPN Monday Night Football, Vikings Bears at 8:30.
Away from your TV for Capital One Bowl Week? Watch it live, online at ESPN360.com. Replay the games you missed or simply relive the biggest moments by clicking key plays. Don't miss a moment of Capital One Bowl Week. ESPN360.com, where to watch when you can't watch.
Here, kitty, kitty. Clipping kitty's claws is impossible. Now kitty can trim her own claws with Emery Cat, the fun new kitty scratcher that grooms cat's claws while they play. Clippers cut too close, causing pain. But Emery Cat's honeycomb design works like a powerful emery board. When infused with catnip, kitty keeps coming back for safe groomed nails. The arch design is ideal for larger cats too. It even has a playful toy. Ordinary posts cost $100 and won't trim your cat's claws, but Emery Cat is just $19.95 with durable base, emery board infused with catnip, and cat toy. As a bonus, you also get the de-shedder. It goes deep down to the undercoat to help eliminate shedding. It's a $15 value, free. Call now and we'll send you a second Emery Cat and de-shedder, free. Just pay processing and handling. Two Emery Cat boards plus 2D shedders for just $19.95. Call now.
To order your Emery Cat board for $19.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-818-6207. That's 1-800-818-6207 or go online at emerycat.com.
Back in San Francisco, 14-6, Trojans on top of Boston College. Maybe one of the reasons they don't have one of their stars, Mark Herzlick. And Mark, what a year it's been for you. Can you put it into words?
You know, it's tough. It's, some people say it's been a roller coaster, and, it really has. It was tough back in May. I got diagnosed with Ewing sarcoma cancer, and all the way up until November 3rd was my last treatment. And just recently, I've been diagnosed that, you know, said that I was clean of cancer and, you know, back ready to go.
You had a surgery recently, put a rod in your leg. What does that mean to you as far as you're coming back and being able to play again? I know you like that play.
Yeah, that was nice. Being able to, you know, be told by a doctor that I'm going to be able to play again was awesome. I always thought I could again, but to hear it come out of his mouth was great.
For not only Boston College fans, but for football fans across the country, where can they find you next fall?
You know, I'll be on the sidelines with the rest of the boys in maroon and gold.
Dressed
and ready to play.
Good luck to you. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Back to you, Joe.
All right, he's hoping to be alongside Wes Davis, who just came up with the interception of Matt Barkley's long ball there.
Yeah, a little bit of pressure on Barkley, and then he's unable to get enough on this as he was trying to get to Williams, and that ball hung. Williams is open. He was behind the defense. Ball's underthrown because of the pressure, and Davis comes up with the pick.
First mistake of the night for Barkley. He was nearly flawless. He was 13 of 14, two touchdowns, 164 yards, and then that. Harris now. Montel Harris. Good, strong run of 16 yards. Yeah, that touchdown to cap that last drive as Matt Barkley looks to stay warm and dry on the sideline after throwing that interception. We'll see how he responds. But for now, Dave Shinsky and company, a chance to take advantage. Harris unable to get much against the middle of that line. Let's take a look back at our Mazda drive recap.
Now that last time the USC defense was on the field, they got cut up by the Wildcat and power running. Montel Harris in the Wildcat. Montel Harris behind a powerful offensive line. And then finally, the power running, pulling the guard, pulling the tight end, and getting into the end zone. Just as we've seen USC struggle against other teams in the second half of the season against a powerful running attack.
Shinsky gets it quickly to Larmon Jr. out to the 37-yard line. That's a gain of 8.
And now Boston College starting to get into a rhythm, mixing it up, throwing a little bit on first down, keeping SC off balance, not knowing when they're going to try and pound the ball, when they're going to run it, keeping USC from loading the box with 8 or 9 guys.
Coach Spaz, will he call upon Montel Harris again here, 3rd and 1. Harris taken down in the backfield and then fights forward.
Are you kidding me?
Wow, what a second effort that was.
He did not have that at first. And that's the thing I'm talking about. We talked earlier about when you see him on tape, you know, first couple times you go, not real big, not real fast. And then you see him do things like that, where he carries tacklers to get a first down.
He was nearly down in the backfield here. He was going the wrong way.
Exactly what I'm talking about. Now, part of that comes from his history. This guy has great balance, grew up doing martial arts, has great balance from all that, and says it helps him with his game. He knows how to glance off blows and how to handle his balance and weight.
As a black belt in karate, fresh set of downs. Now lots of time for Shinsky, and this ball is complete across midfield as he's able to get it to Colin Larmon Jr., a gain of 13.
I tell you, we saw Shinsky in practice earlier this week. Had a couple days where he did not throw the football like that. Right now, he's playing with a lot of confidence and throwing the ball very well. Take a look at this. Confidence, nice pat, knows where he wants to go with the football. This is a guy who was a pitcher in the minor leagues for 7 years.
25-year-old freshman. I'm just looking for him to manage the game tonight and contribute a little. And ride Montel Harris and a solid defense. Here is Harris again. And driving forward again to the 44, and a late flag comes in. And there is Dave Shinsky, drafted in the 4th round. He was with the Minnesota Twins organization in the 2003 Major League Draft.
He was taken 118th, just four picks.
Personal foul, offense, number 78. 15-yard penalty, second down.
That's Thomas Claiborne. Now back in that draft of 03, Shinsky was taken just four picks behind the Red Sox, Jason Papelbon.
Wow.
But the career didn't go the way he thought it would. Finished up with the Toronto Blue Jays AA affiliate, the New Hampshire Fisher Cats. And BC was shopping for a quarterback this offseason. Shinsky had his eligibility, and the match was made. So now backed up to a second and 20 after the personal foul. Just when they had things rolling, did BC. Shinsky floats it out, and that is out of bounds. Will Harris corralled it, but was out.
And Tess, go back to that personal foul on Thomas Claiborne. Sometimes offensive linemen come in late to try and clean up a pile and help out their guys. That's a cheap shot against a defenseless player. We've seen it all season long. You will always get flagged for that when there is a defenseless player and the officials are right there.
It's not a smart play. Completely unnecessary. And because of that, and then the incompletion of third and 20. Shinsky tried to dump it off, and a flag comes in. He tried to just dump it off to his tight end, Chris Pantelli, and they may get a first down out of this deal.
Yeah, Michael Morgan got there quickly, a little bit too quickly. Morgan is about 220. He was playing against the tight end, Pantelli, and Pantelli is a lot bigger, and he's trying to work around him, and he just kind of grabbed him. Well, here's the deal. Watch your left arm. There's Morgan. Watch the turn. Now, here's the deal, Tess. You can put your left arm on a receiver, and the officials won't call it. But when you turn the guy, they assume that that is affecting the play, and you will be flagged. So you want to put your hand down low, and you don't want to turn the guy.
Yeah, and the sin there is that didn't have the look of a play that was going to pick up 20 yards. So a fresh set of downs for the Eagles. Pressure being shown now by SC. A flag comes in.
Offense, number 2. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
So Montel Harris, a little bit of movement there. Jeremiah Masoli is going to lead the Pac-10 champs. The Oregon Ducks against Terrell Pryor and the Ohio State Buckeyes in the granddaddy of them all. The 2010 Rose Bowl game presented by Citi. New Year's Day, 4:30 Eastern on ABC. The Rose Bowl lives here.
The big, big game for Ohio State. Their first Rose Bowl since, when, 99, 98, or 97?
Well, they played for some national championships. Gunnell now. Rich Gunnell right down the middle of the field. How about this? Hello, end zone! Touchdown reception. Just what the doctor ordered. Abanovichus, remember, missed the extra point earlier. This one, up and good. USC had this game going in a direction BC wanted no part of. But back come the Eagles.
You know, Dr. Burke, Sometimes I feel like burning this whole place down.
Great. That sounds like real progress.
It was after three. Your blood sugar was low. Eat some emerald nuts. They'll keep you focused.
Banish the 3 p.m. slump with the natural energy of emerald nuts.
It's a great car. Show me the Carfax.
I'll give you $500 off.
Show me the Carfax.
I'll throw in the oil changes.
Just show me the Carfax.
A Carfax report can help you choose a great used car. It's free at thousands of reputable dealers. Just say, show me the Carfax.
Could switching to Geico really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Is Ed too tall, Jones? Too tall?
I was gonna guesstimate.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Wow, that picture is stunning.
Yeah, it's my new Toshiba LED TV. 240 hertz, super deep blacks. How cool is that design?
It's fabulous. And I don't even like baseball. Why are we sticking with this cover, too?
We got a blitz.
Blitz? They just check off to a middle screen and hit the H-back on a release. Blitz.
The Toshiba LED TV. It's a game changer. Toshiba, leading innovation.
Will you marry me?
Sure. Where's the flag?
My top pick this season, Applebee's 2 for 20 game time lineup. Let's break it down. One appetizer to share, two entrees. Final score, $20. This deal could go all the way. 2 for 20, only at Applebee's.
I need pain relief that won't mess with my grip.
The new Icy Hot No Mess Applicator. Massages and long-lasting relief for shoulders, knees, backs, even arthritis. Icy to dull pain, hot to relax it away. Icy Hot No Mess Applicator.
No pain, no mess.
Joe Rod and Todd with you here in San Francisco for the Emerald Bowl, and this has turned out to be a heck of a game. USC, the only difference in the game right now, the missed extra point. BC just closed it on this 61-yard touchdown pass to Rich Gannell.
Now, Taylor Mays is playing three deep coverage. He's a deep guy in the middle. Watch him overrun this bad angle. He has this ability to make this play, but he's thinking that Gannell isn't in the slot. He's thinking outside. Look where he is. He overruns it. Gannell simply comes inside, and now he's free. You got Taylor Mays, number two, out of position. Gannell cuts inside of it, and what should have been maybe a 15-yard gain is now a touchdown.
And with that, Rich Gannell becomes Boston College's all-time leader in receiving yardage. The senior from East Windsor, New Jersey. Over 2,400 yards receiving in his career. Ahead of Pitt Mitchell, who was such a fine tight end, went on to be a good pro. And the BC offense playing with confidence now. C.J. Gable. Look at Gable, shifty. Flag comes down as he gets out to the 40.
C.J. Gable is carrying the pick on the 6. That was the 40-yard line.
During the return, holding, receiving team, number 57, 10-yard penalty, first down.
So Uncle Mo, that momentum has shifted in this game. Frank Spaziani. Todd Harris told us about that relaxed approach after the missed extra point, confident in his team and what they are capable of, and they have come back strong here.
Yes, they have. Scrappy Boston College team all season long.
Barkley back under center. Bradford gets the call. Taken down after a minimal gain. Now let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio for a look at what's coming up on the Cars.com halftime report. Hopefully a fashion report, Reese. I know you like that fashion.
No question about it, Joe, and you guys are the height of men's fashion tonight. The height of the college football world, the news of Urban Meyer and his decision to step down as the head coach at Florida. Two of our analysts have spoken with Urban directly. You'll hear from both of them coming up at halftime. A couple of very entertaining bowl games in the earlier part of the day. Pitt, North Carolina, Marshall, Ohio. We'll show you the highlights.
Barkley now with some time. And that ball is behind the intended receiver, Johnson. I joke with Reese because earlier today he was talking about what we were wearing when we were with Pete Carroll. And I thought that he was trying out to be a reporter on Project Runway.
Oh, he saw the Christmas gifts that we exchanged. The sweaters and all, huh?
Right now, Pete Carroll would like to get himself a gift here and get this offense moving again. It's been an interesting year for USC. Remember, they started off as the elite power that everybody's known them to be for this decade. And then things started to go south. Now they're trying to find themselves here in a postseason against an overachieving BC bunch. Barkley, complete to Osbury.
That's going to be close.
Right at that line. Osbury is such a big target, 6'4", 235. USC sideline as they split it here with BC. You know, all good things have to come to an end.
Well, you know, actually, you look at this season and first time in 7 years that they've had some issues.
First down now for the Trojans, and here's Williams out to the 31-yard line, close to the 32.
Any other team in the country that loses its premier starting quarterback and loses eight guys off their defense, you wouldn't have them in the top five.
Absolutely not.
But USC started in the top five, and they probably shouldn't have. Inexperienced quarterback and an inexperienced defense, and you got this result. And I think Pete Carroll had a sense that this was going to happen this season.
Up until this year, USC had seven consecutive AP top four finishes, seven straight BC bowl appearances. Havili wrapped up at the 32.
I think the bigger issue for USC and Pete Carroll isn't the fact that they lost four games this season and that they played a young quarterback and an inexperienced defense. I think it's the culture and being concerned about what's happened postseason. That you have several guys with academic issues, that you have a guy in an issue about whether he's eligible for extra benefits
Joe
and whatnot.
McKnight.
And the program can't be about just the NFL because that becomes selfish. And Pete Carroll's got to get that leadership back with his players to make sure they don't have those issues anymore.
Third and three. Just overthrows David Osbury. So the BC defense does their job against Matt Barkley again. Marcellus Bowman and DeLeon Gauze had coverage that time. Just over a minute to go in this first half. It's been a tale of two quarters here. USC early on and then BC now with the momentum.
I think you agree that there is a lot of talent coming back for USC next season.
Barkley and company, wide receivers. This takes a bounce and rolls just inside the 30. So 59 seconds to go. Pete Carroll is ninth year at USC. And of course, all the success from 06, the BCS title game lost to Texas, and then the three consecutive Rose Bowls in 07, 08, and 09.
Yeah, you think about beating Michigan in 07, Illinois in 08, and they were just pounding folks. Pounded Penn State 2009. It's been on a roll, and you get a lot of top recruits. You start talking about the NFL. I don't think they have a big problem now, but Carroll has an opportunity to restate things and get people back on the same page and develop those players who are leaders who say, hey, we're about winning, we're about championships. It's not just about going to play in the NFL.
You know, and Pete Carroll also gave credit to the rest of the Pac-10. He said playing in the Pac-10 at the end of this year, that was a tough task.
Oh, yeah, and I agree with him. You know, and that's why I don't think the issue is the fact that he played a young quarterback and had inexperienced defense. They'll overcome that. They just have to make sure that the culture they've had for the last 7 years remains and doesn't get lost because of what's happened in this postseason.
Speaking of tough tests, this Boston College team has come in well prepared and ready for this USC team tonight. And Dave Schinske. Dave Schinske has been the question mark all season long. But tonight, he hasn't hurt the Eagles at all. Had the long touchdown pass to Rich Gannell. As the penalty stops the clock.
You know, that was the big question mark, Rod, was we understand what BC's all about, but the inconsistencies of Schinske could hurt them.
Yeah.
He's played a fine first half of football.
Oh, absolutely. I agree completely. He has been the difference. We thought, and USC thought coming in, that if they really shut down the running attack, Schinske couldn't beat him. But Schinske's made enough plays to allow the running game to be good.
Had the two touchdown passes to his fullback Stanley Havili. USC was up 14-0. Then the hard running from Montel Harris, and then the big play, Dave Schinske to Rich Gannell. Coach Spaziani has to be happy, Todd Harris.
All right, thank you, Joe. Coach, tale of two different quarters. How were you able to get the momentum back on your side in that second quarter?
Well, we were able to get the ball and run it a little bit and make some plays on the ground. And usually when you do that, good things happen to your offense.
Your quarterback looks like he's settled down. What are you telling Uncle Dave on the sideline, your 25-year-old freshman?
Tell him make sure he calls the plays right and get him right. He's a little nervous to start out.
Message to the team at the half.
Well, we were in a ball game. We got to try and do what we always do, take it to the fourth quarter, and hopefully we can make a drive at the end and do something.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Joe.
Thanks, Todd. Uncle Dave Schinske, 159 yards, and that big touchdown pass. A 14-13 game here in San Francisco. Let's join Reese, Lou Holtz, and Mark May back in the studio. For welcome you back to the 2009 Emerald Bowl, part of Capital One Bowl Week. Here in San Francisco, Joe Tessitore, Rod Gilmore, and Todd Harris with you. A missed extra point, the only difference in the game. So many people said, would USC be up for this game? Would they be motivated? They were up. They were motivated. They just ran into a very good second quarter out of Boston College. BC played very well in that second quarter. Let's look at the five-hour energy playbook and Montel Harris, Rod.
Yeah, well, the playbook really came about because of Dave Schinske making plays in the passing game, which allowed the running game to really have an impact on the USC defense. Here's the Wildcat, which really got things going in the second quarter. Montel Harris, big run, couple of jukes, got the offense moving on the ground. And then how about the big run in the middle of the field, that power run where they pull the guard, get a block, and get Montel Harris running like so many other teams did against USC in the second half. They pounded them on the ground after the passing game opened it up a little bit.
Pete Carroll said, hey, I know what this BC team is all about. They're just like their coach. They're tough and they're hard-nosed. Frank Spaziani has made a career of that style of football, and that's what he got his team to do in that second quarter. 14-13, USC to receive the ball here, and a short kick is fielded at the 38 as BC stays away from the dangerous return game again. Adam Goodman fielding that. Todd?
Joe, I had a chance to talk with head coach Pete Carroll of USC, and he said, hey, we're not panicking here. See, we always teach the kids that it's 0-0 at halftime, so this is no big deal. He said, it really comes down to two mistakes on two big plays. Other than that, we're fine. I said, coach, what is the message to your team going to the second half? He said, I want these guys to finish. That's all I care about, finish and finish strong.
Barkley to start things off, and that ball was intercepted. Marcellus Bowman. Take it down inside the 10-yard line. Wow, what a start to the second half for Boston College.
And Tess, Marcellus Bowman made a great play, reading the eyes of the quarterback. He stares down Matt Barkley as Matt Barkley stares down his receiver. Watch his eyes. Never looks anywhere but right there. Bowman sees that, steps in front. Great play, great hands, and a great start for Boston College in the second half here. He just read the quarterback's eyes. Barkley led him right to it.
Marcellus Bowman the senior from Ohio who waited his turn. One of the hardest hitting safeties in the ACC. A ball hawk there. Harris now. Shifty down to the 6 yard line, a gain of 3.
Last time Boston College was inside the 20, inside the red zone, they were able to simply power the ball across the goal line. They got Harris in behind one of the guards after they pulled him to the inside, and Harris fought his way into the end zone. Can they just power over the USC front as they did late in the second quarter?
Two tight ends here on second and goal. Loose ball. USC picks it up. Jarrell Casey fighting for more yardage. Big return out to the 32. Wow, USC's defense comes up huge. So they trade turnovers to open up this second half. BC was knocking on the door, and USC's defense just slammed it shut.
Yeah, bad exchange. Third time that they have lost the ball in this ballgame. Jarrell Casey comes up in a great athletic move. Managed to do a little pirouette and keep his balance and get an extra 20 yards out of that after he picked this ball up. And as Boston College tried to yank it out, he wouldn't give up that football.
He's their most active defensive lineman, and he leads the team in fumble recoveries, and a big one there. So Barkley back to business, hands off to Bradford. And here goes Allen Bradford. Out to the 48-yard line. 16-yard gain for the junior running back, who's starting in place of Joe McKnight, who's in the midst of an investigation of dealing with a possible improper benefit and is being held out of action tonight until that situation can be cleared up.
At one point, Bradford thought about transferring. He was a defensive player, safety, linebacker, moved him over to offense, didn't get on the field much. Tonight, he's a starter.
Getting some more work here. The midfield and just a yard beyond. Allen Bradford goes 235 pounds, gives him more power in that lone back spot. You know, you talk about him being a fine defensive player. Oregon head coach at the time, Mike Bellotti, recruited him as what he was saying, well, quote, the best linebacker I ever saw at that stage.
Yeah.
Well, but here he is as a tailback.
Yeah, you can see he explodes on contact, and that's what you want out of linebackers. He does that as a running back.
Getting work again, but meeting him right there was Mike McLaughlin. A loss of one.
There's a
sixth tackle of the night for McLaughlin.
There's a guy who's an impact player for this defense and a guy that they missed early on in the season.
He was out earlier, tore his right Achilles tendon during spring practices. His second season as the team captain. They call him Mac, and he plays like a Mack truck.
Typically on third down, USC likes to go max protection, keep a lot of blockers in to protect Barkley as you take a look at Herzlich on the sideline.
Mark Herzlich trying to get a stop for his defense instead. It is a first down for the Trojans down to the 30-yard line. Ronald Johnson with a 20-yard reception. Glad you're with us here for the eighth playing of the Emerald Bowl. Joe Tessitore alongside Rod Gilmore, Todd Harris down on the sideline. It has been a very entertaining night. USC and BC both came in with 8-4 records. Of course, for USC, the first time in 7 years that they're not playing in a BCS bowl game. They jumped out to a 14-zip lead, and Boston College charged back. Play action now. Barkley trying to direct traffic, and he gets a complete to Williams. And watch out for Williams in the open field. Damian Williams inside the 15-yard line.
Well, Barkley was in charge on that play. Half row, he had two receivers out there. He told Williams to come back to him. Watch him as he gets out. He's going to point and tell Williams, I want you to come back here. There he is. And Williams does as he's told. You see it from this angle. Comes back in there. Nice catch. The guy who very well could be playing his last game at USC before heading off to the NFL as a wide receiver.
That's been the talk all week long. The junior from Arkansas, who was a team MVP. Motion here.
Dead ball. False start. Entire line. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Entire line? The entire line.
You like that?
Well, then they all had the right idea. Somebody else had the wrong number, the wrong count. The entire line.
This is a potential big swing moment as BC had opened up this second half with the Marcellus Bowman interception. They had first and goal, and then a turnover goes the other way, the fumble, and now USC marching. Barkley sets up and just throws it out of bounds. Pete Carroll continues to see the progression of his freshman quarterback, the 19-year-old Matt Barkley, who started off this game so strong. Just one incompletion in the early going, the two touchdown passes, and now trying to bounce back after throwing two interceptions.
But he's rarely been under pressure. He's thrown the picks by staring down coverage, trying to force a ball in also. But he has not been under a lot of duress back there. Boston College, not a blitzing team.
Wide receiver screen to Williams. Now reverses field. Barkley out in front blocking. Williams still on his feet after the missed tackle and down to the 10-yard line, and a late flag comes in. Matt Barkley got out in front, put a block on Roderick Rollins.
Illegal block in the back. Offense, number 8. 10-yard penalty. Replay, second down.
So we'll move him back.
Yeah, that was Rojo, Ronald Johnson, who got the bad block. But watch Barkley, number 7. He does the right job there on Rollins. He gets right into him. Now the bad play is at the back of it right there. You see number 8. There he is, Rojo, coming in on Keekly. That's the block in the back.
So it's still second down, but it makes for second and 18 now for Barkley. Rojo here, unable to haul it in. So they'll make for third and long.
And he had him. He had him out there. I mean, Rojo was open. He just missed him. And he hasn't missed much tonight. But this one, he had it. And he knows it.
Sailed off on him. Pushed it out to the side much too much as Ronald Johnson had made that cut.
The offensive line has held up well, even on the right side. Matt Khalil has stepped in for Tyron Smith, who's ineligible for this ball game.
And Barkley unable to make anything of that. So it'll make for a fourth down. Luke Kuechly quick to get to him. A freshman linebacker who they call Keek the Freak. He just gets after that ball, an all ACC first teamer, second in the nation in tackles.
I'm amazed. Keep in mind, he was a safety in high school. Had never played linebacker. And he's the rookie of the year in the ACC as a linebacker.
Sky's the limit with his future. Jordan Congdon now, former walk-on who earned a scholarship from 38 yards out. And Congdon puts it through. So USC is able to take advantage of the turnover. We told you about Herzlick and the inspiration he has. USC has an inspiration of their own. We'll talk to Jake Olson when we return.
Now during the GMC holiday event, get our best offer of the year, 0% APR for 72 months. Or you can get $5,500 total cash back on select 2009 Sierras in stock.
Hi, is Denise working?
Yeah, she's in the back. Can I take your order?
I'm just a little bit more comfortable ordering with Denise.
Bye.
Hey, hi, you remember me? I came by yesterday, gave me that five-layer burrito, that new one for
89 cents.
Is that cool? Is that still cool?
It's an inside deal for everyone. Layers of seasoned beef, cheddar cheese, and a hidden layer of nacho cheese sauce. It's Taco Bell's new beefy five-layer burrito for just 89 cents. Why pay more?
They say the war tore a hole in the sky. Our only hope is in my hands.
We need that book.
It's not a choice. It's always a choice.
It's not a book, it's a weapon!
Some would kill to have it. I will kill to protect it.
The Book of Eli, rated R, starts January 15th.
When the flu hits you hard, hit right back with Theraflu. Nothing fights your worst flu symptoms with more power. Theraflu, good to be back.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
That young man is Jake Olsen with his dad, Brian. He has touched the hearts of the entire USC family. Courageously battling cancer, he lost his vision to the disease. Pete Carroll has treated him so very well. He spent his last day of having sight with the Trojans team. Todd?
No question about it. Jake Olsen is the man. And Jake, I'm going to turn to you and get a little insight. What does Pete Carroll and the Trojans, what do they need to do to get control of this game?
I don't know. My dad's been narrating to me that that number two running back has really gone against our defense. So let's try to hold the run game back and try to get our run game up and throw the ball and, you know, play some offense and defense.
You haven't let the setback of losing your sight get you down too much. You've got high hopes, high spirits still going. What has this year meant to you being around Pete Carroll and the Trojans?
Unbelievable. It's like a dream, you know. My family's been there with me this whole time, and just the team's been with me this whole time, and I hope to see them next year, so.
All right, well, the Trojans are driving. It looks like they may have a turnover here, and I got to ask your dad one question. I hear your dad is doing a pretty good job of being Joe Tessitore. Where'd you learn your skills, sir?
Well, I don't know. I'm just going with the flow and all of this. It's been wonderful. Trojans have been wonderful. And Jake is doing really well. And that's what's really lifted us all up, and even the Trojans, to see Jake do so well.
All right. Well, there's three kings of L.A., Pete Carroll, Kobe Bryant, and my man here, Jake Olsen. Happy New Year, guys.
All right, you too.
Happy New Year.
What a great young man Jake Olsen is.
You know, first time we saw the story on SportsCenter. On game day, rather, just amazed. You know, hard to watch that with just without being impressed and moved by that young man, and also by Pete Carroll and his program embracing that young man.
How about this? BC going with a pistol offense and the inside handoff to Montel Harris. So we've seen a little bit of everything from the Eagles tonight, Rod.
Yeah, but the consistent thing we've seen from the second quarter on, midway through the second quarter, is a powerful running game. Regardless of whether it's pistol, a wildcat, or lining up in a traditional two-back set, they've been pounding USC inside.
Heard Jake say, hey, my dad's telling me this number two is pretty awesome. That's Montel Harris. And here he is again. Yeah, he is pretty awesome. Another first down for BC. Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN tomorrow night. Kentucky and Clemson in the Gaylord Hotel's Music City Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN. Also on ESPN360.com tomorrow night, 8:30 Eastern. In fact, you can log on to ESPN360.com and stay with us tonight. We will have full coverage of the trophy presentation here at the Emerald Bowl and the announcing of the offensive and defensive MVPs on ESPN360.com. Shinsky to pass. Has time. Just floats it out there, and it falls incomplete, but what a dangerous toss by Shinsky. It was tipped by Kennard. Kevin Thomas had a shot at it as well. Neither one of them could cut up with it.
No, Shinsky made up his mind. He was going to throw the route regardless, and it was covered. Nobody open at all. He threw directly into coverage. Kennard had a shot at it. Kevin Thomas had a shot at it. The only person who didn't have a shot was Shinsky's receiver.
That's right. Well, Shinsky still has not had that one costly moment tonight that he's been prone to in playing against very athletic defenses. It's a pass on second down. Lofts it up for Jarvis, and that's incomplete.
Yeah, and that wasn't open either.
He was covered by Sharice Wright, the cornerback who was expected to be the starter at the beginning of the season but was ruled academically ineligible, so he missed the season. Now he returns and has performed well enough in the classroom to get back out there on the field.
Well, you see this from young quarterbacks sometimes. They make up their mind to throw somewhere. He didn't even recognize that coverage was complete over there. There was nowhere to go with that.
Third and 10, James McCluskey is the lone back. He provides some pass protection for Shinsky. Three receivers, two by one. Line to make is the 49. Pressure. Gets it away and throws behind his intended receiver, Rich Gunnell. So it'll bring up a fourth down. Shinsky's a little upset with himself.
He's a former pitcher, and I guess if you were drawing a baseball comparison, you'd say that he was missing the plate. He was a little outside, a little high.
You think he'd be comfortable here at AT&T Park, home to the Giants, but...
It used to bother me to hear people talk about young freshmen. All freshmen are young.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
He's 25 years old, but there's still a learning curve.
Exactly.
So Ryan Quigley on to punt to Damian Williams. Line drive, takes a bounce, touched a player. Looked like it touched a USC player, and BC jumps on it. They go the other way. The way Luke Kuechly reacted, you swore that it hit the heel of a USC special teamer. Here's a look. You tell me, Rod. His right foot seemingly made contact right there.
Yeah, that's
as clear as day. We're going to take a break. They're sure to review it.
Grandma's favorite movie is The Dark Knight?
Yeah, she loves the Batman voice.
You wanted me. Here I am.
She is good.
So is Bobby.
You're garbage, Joker. Where's Harvey Dent? Let her go!
If they're not careful, they could...
Where is he?
Where is he?
Where is he?
Know your limits, Master Wayne.
For a great movie night, make it pop.
Now during the GMC holiday event, get our best offer of the year, 0% APR for 72 months. Or you can get $5,500 total cash back on select 2009 Sierras in stock.
Look closely.
This $50 Buffalo gold piece is the first United States coin ever struck using .9999, that's four nines, pure 24-karat gold. The U.S. government had to stop production because of a shortage of specially made gold blanks. No wonder the last edition price is going through the roof. Now you can reserve your own copy, clad in 31 milligrams of pure gold. The final issue price was to be set at $50 per proof, but now this private non-monetary gold-clad masterpiece can be yours for only $19.95. With gold skyrocketing, price can only be guaranteed for 7 days. Each 2010 Gold Buffalo Tribute proof is clad in 31 milligrams of pure gold, is proof struck, and utilizes the famous Buffalo nickel design. Strict limit of 5 proofs per caller. You must hurry. Call now.
Call 1-800-798-9439. That's 1-800-798-9439. Strict limit of 5 proofs per caller at 1-800-798-9439.
Referee Dan Romeo talking with the replay official. It seemed pretty apparent that on that punt, DJ Shoemate, the special teams player for Pete Carroll, had his foot touch the ball, and Luke Kuechly, the linebacker for BC, jumped on it. Look at the right foot.
That's the
kicks
first touching, and then there was a touching by number 45, Wes Davis, but that was after the ball had already been touched, and I believe the official saw the second part of that.
Understood.
He saw Wes Davis. He did not see the ball hit the USC player.
Well, the ruling on the field was USC ball. But they're taking a long look at this here.
So you know what that means. The
look
ruling
of concern
on the field.
On Pete Carroll's yeah. face.
You gotta have.
No, he touches it first, Rod.
You gotta have indisputable evidence to overturn the call on the field. And that would seem to be indisputable video evidence that it touched the USC player first.
We've taken a long time on this review, and now they're talking it over as they've removed the headsets. But it appeared that DJ Shoemate, the right foot, made contact with that rolling punt. And the word we're getting is that the officials are talking over the wording of the ruling to make this announcement of the judgment of the review. 4-point ball game, halfway through the third, and this would be a big swing of field position.
Huge. It would put Boston College right at the 30-yard line. Down 4. Coming off a series in which they struggled trying to throw the ball.
After further review, the USC player was blocked and forced into contacting the ball. Therefore, by rule, he is not meant to have touched the ball. First down, SC.
Well, take a look at the play, and we'll see. Was he blocked into the ball?
He's coming. He's engaged.
He's engaged. He
I don't
wasn't
know that
blocked
he's blocked into the ball, though.
Yeah, I don't agree with that.
Because he's actually coming forward and kicks the ball forward. If he was blocked, he'd be going backwards.
Yeah.
But that's a tough one. That's a tricky one. But it was obvious that he made contact. But USC's football nonetheless. And now Bradford is wrapped up by Kuechly and McLaughlin. We have had some interesting instant replay moments here in this game. It started with that long pass to Damian Williams that set up USC's second touchdown of the night. And then right there on the special teams play, which could have given Frank Spaziani prime field position here, only down by 4. Instead, now an opportunity for Matt Barkley and the USC offense to try to push things a bit here against this BC defense. Complete. And Rojo crosses to the 43-yard line. Ronald Johnson, he is a very good receiver for USC. Damian Williams gets so much attention. But Johnson, the junior from Michigan, broke his collarbone back in August, missed 5 games this year. He's a very good player for this offense.
He's a speedster and a guy who can really catch the football well. I think it really hurt USC not to have him in the first 5 games of the year. I think it slowed the development of their passing attack.
McNeil now. And McNeil is taken down by Kuechly. The whistle came in late there. McNeil reacted and said, you know, I was rolled over. But the ruling is that he was down. Curtis McNeil is a redshirt freshman who's getting some playing time tonight in the absence of Joe McKnight. Alan Bradford got the start. We saw C.J. Gable, and now McNeil. Let's take a look here and see if he was down. Rolls over, yeah, and his knee was down.
But, you know, and I have a problem with, you know, the whistle not being blown. I think when a guy is down, whether he touches, he's on somebody, you've got to pull
the play.
Well,
that could be dangerous.
Exactly.
That could be very dangerous. You don't want a defensive player while the guy's rolling, coming in and just getting to somebody full steam. And now Havili, look at the power running by Stanley Havili. What a night he's had here. Listen to this. And for anybody who believes USC isn't up for playing some football and getting after it tonight, watch out for Stanley Havili. He's had two touchdowns tonight, and he's hard charging here in the second half. Three-step drop, complete to Williams. Williams gets past two defenders, and there he goes. Loose ball, but it goes out of bounds. 26 yards for Damian Williams.
And it's just a quick slant and a bad angle on the backside by the corner out there, who's Gauze. And Williams almost went. I mean, Williams made the nice quick cut inside. Ball was thrown high, and Gauze thought he had maybe a play on it and misjudged where Williams was.
Good solid drive by this USC offense. Damian Williams, 116 yards on the night. Remember, this drive started with the replay ruling that gave them possession after what looked to be a turnover on special teams. Incomplete. Bryce Butler was the intended target for Barkley.
But that was big time. Barkley, we saw him stare someone down earlier and get picked. He did not stare that one down. He looked off the safety to the left and then came back to the right and threw a bullet. Watch this. He comes back with that. Look at this ball. That is right there.
That's a pro throw right there.
That's big time. That is big time. And Bryce Butler has to come up with that one.
That's an example of what this young man possesses. Stanley Havili, the lone back here on second and 10. Play action. Williams dragging across. Gets it fed to him. And is out just at the 15-yard line. So another reception for Damian Williams. Nine catches, 121 yards.
And we're seeing USC shift away from the running attack and more towards throwing. The last two or three series, they've relied on Barkley. They've gotten away from the rushing attack, and it goes back to our concern early about whether up front they'd have more of an issue than missing McKnight. But the two players missing up front for them would be the bigger issue in their rushing attack.
Right tackle Tyron Smith, tight end Anthony McCoy, academically ineligible. Williams again, this time nothing doing. Right away, Williams went down as Mike Morrissey saw that play coming.
What a smart player he is. Mike Morrissey, son of Jim Morrissey. There he is. Watch him see this play, attack it right away. His dad played in the NFL as a linebacker for 9 years.
Part of that Chicago Bears team that won Super Bowl 20. Morrissey's been coming on strong with 22 tackles in his last five games. So Jordan Congdon on for a 35-yarder. He made from 38 earlier. And that came up short. This has been a wild third quarter.
Did he slip on that? He had nothing behind that.
Turnovers back and forth. Couple good offensive plays, but in the end, nothing to show for it. Remember, Abanava just slipped earlier. It rained for an hour and a half before kickoff. That gave way to that plant foot. More to come. Stay with us. ESPN Monday Night Football, Vikings-Bears at 8:30.
Man, what happened here?
It was after three. Your blood sugar was low. You should eat them emerald nuts. They'll keep you alert.
Vanish the 3 p.m. slump with the natural energy of emerald nuts.
All right, let's lock her down.
So what do you think?
Let's go with the
basic package.
Good choice.
Only Meineke gives you options on complete car care, and we'll help you choose what's right for you, your car, and your budget. At Meineke, you're always the driver.
I need pain relief that won't mess with my grip.
The new Icy Hot No Mess Applicator. Massages in long-lasting relief for shoulders, knees, backs, even arthritis. Icy to dull pain, hot to relax it away. Icy Hot No Mess Applicator.
No pain, no mess.
What are you looking for? A hairbrush for a Rapunzel Barbie doll?
Oh.
Holiday savings are still happening at Walmart. Starting this Saturday, come to Walmart's Garden Center and get 50% off Christmas items. Save money, live better. Walmart.
Shoot, do it. Let's go, Brian. Shoot, do it.
On the air and behind the scenes, SportsCenter.com covers the people, headlines, and highlights that have the sports world buzzing.
It's the best week of the year, Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN. Tuesday at 8, Miami, Wisconsin. Wednesday at 8, Arizona, Nebraska.
ESPN College Football, the Emerald Bowl, is brought to you by Emerald Nuts. Stay sharp at 3 p.m. with natural energy from Emerald Nuts. GMC, we are professional grade. And Amway Global, celebrating 50 years of making better products for better lives.
A visit to the Rock, Alcatraz, out there in the Bay. We're in San Francisco, and USC and BC were out there in the Rock earlier this week, and right now they are rocking this AT&T Park in what has been a very intriguing Emerald Bowl. Joe Tessitore, Rod Gilmore, and Todd Harris with you. Frank Spaziani, seen a little bit of everything tonight, hasn't he, Rod? Down 14 early, his team comes back with power running, and then the turnovers and the instant replay calls and the momentum swings, and now his offense back out on the field after the missed field goal, trailing here 17-13 to Pete Carroll's Trojans.
And back to the power running and the Wildcat, Montel Harris.
Montel Harris lined up for that direct snap. Keeps it himself. That whole middle was clogged up right away, and the Trojans force them all the way back. Armand Armstead all over him. The 2010 Rose Bowl game presented by Citi. It is going to be a good one. Jeremiah Masoli and those Ducks. Terrell Pryor and the Buckeyes. Number 7 versus number 8. Coverage begins New Year's Day at 4:30 Eastern on ABC. The Rose Bowl lives here.
Do you think people realize that LaMichael James of Oregon is the third leading rusher in the country?
They lost LeGarrette Blount to the suspension. He stepped up and had a sensational year. Watch out for him on New Year's Day. Here's Shinsky on 2nd and 11. Threw it behind the target again. He was trying to get it to Chris Pantelli.
Yeah, he's been struggling lately. His last 4 or 5 throws have been off the mark. Had a great first half. Has not found the rhythm here in the third quarter. And that makes it tougher on the running attack. And that's why they did so well in the second quarter. Shinsky made some plays, and that opened things up for Harris. Now it's tough to run when Shinsky isn't making plays.
Everybody said all week long, Shinsky cannot hurt them. Harris has to help him. Well, right now, 4 straight incompletions for the 25-year-old freshman quarterback. stays up somehow and almost threw an interception. T.J. Bryant just couldn't get his hands on it. Shinsky stood up to the rush and then threw another incompletion. That's five straight.
And Gary Tranquil, the offensive coordinator, is going to find him and say, look, no, it's okay to punt. But that play was dangerous as Montel Harris is down on the field for Boston College.
Rod, that's a worst case scenario for this offense.
Absolutely.
Montel Harris is the one guy that they cannot afford to lose. Harris came in and tried to help out and get a block on Malik Jackson, and he is still down on the ground. So they tend to Montel Harris. Dave Shinsky all of a sudden struggling a bit in the second half. You know, to a certain extent, Shinsky and Barkley tonight, their games have been much like their seasons. There have been moments where you say, wow,
yeah,
you can see why they're getting the ball.
Absolutely.
As freshmen.
Yeah.
And then other moments where you shake your head.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You see the talent, you see the arm strength, you see the accuracy, and you go, that's fantastic. And then there's a stretch where you see three, four bad throws, bad plays in a row, and you go, okay, now we see why they lost the four games and the like. That doesn't mean that's always going to be the case. I mean, these guys will grow a lot from this season to the start of next season.
Quigley's punt fielded by Williams at midfield, and BC quick to surround him. Good special teams coverage by the Eagles. LA sports fans, your new destination for the latest on the teams and players you care about most. It's ESPNLosAngeles.com. USC News, Lakers, Dodgers, Angels, a special LA Sports Center, news, opinion, all the inside info you're accustomed to from ESPN with local flavor, ESPNLosAngeles.com. I think that's going to serve the sports fans of Southern California very, very well. So much always to talk about with the Lakers and, of course, the Trojans. They get more coverage than many NFL teams in major markets. Barkley now. Avili calls it in. He's been very useful out of the backfield. His momentum carried him right over the ESPN side. What do you got working there?
Well, you know, I live with this stuff. I've been on ESPNLosAngeles.com, you know, all day.
I've been
all
watching
week.
All week long.
So I just dial it up and I pull up what I need. And I've got, what do we got coming up here now?
The latest is on Kobe, right?
We got Kobe in there.
Seen that
well, we've got Matt Barkley on there. We've got Barkley on there in the game. What's going on
in
right
game
now?
Coverage.
Yeah.
Hey, go right
that?
There.
That's cool.
ESPNLosAngeles.com. You can go there for post-game coverage of the Trojans tonight. Here's Bradford to the far side, and Bradford is down to the 43-yard line. Allen Bradford, who's been in there instead of Joe McKnight, who, as we told you, is in the midst of that investigation of the possible improper benefit. And Pete Carroll had him down in Los Angeles. He didn't make the trip up with the team to San Francisco and then came up late Wednesday night. He practiced Thursday. And, Rod, we were at practice Thursday with Coach Carroll, and McKnight did not play a big role. And you got the sense that he wasn't going to play at that point. But he wanted him to be part of the team because they feel good about the way things are going with the investigation, but not clarified quite yet. Bradford now chopped down at the knees by Luke Kuechly. What a night for the freshman. Luke Kuechly with 12 tackles tonight.
Hey, having an outrageous night. But you mentioned McKnight. Just think about things from his perspective. You were part of this team all season long, a big part of it. And here's the bowl game. Everybody's up north, and you're in L.A., and you can't be a part of it. That's what Pete Carroll was thinking about. He wanted Joe McKnight to be a part of this, even if he couldn't play.
Snap to Harfman a little off. He gets off the punt. Gunnell's going to let it bounce, and it goes into the end zone. So the BC defense does well there on that exchange. And Boston College will have a fresh set of downs at the 20. Pete Carroll, it's said all week, hey, I got a lot of respect for this BC team and head coach Frank Spaziani. They make the most of what they have. They play tough, and they have done so tonight. I'll tell you, Ron, we talked about it earlier. The analysis for the past couple weeks and the intrigue as to what USC team would show up. You cannot point a finger here and say this USC team wasn't motivated or wasn't enthused about playing.
Are you kidding me?
They're just playing a competitive football game.
Absolutely. I mean, Pete Carroll has made his program about competition, and we watched them practice this week, and they were getting after it.
So after the injury to Montel Harris, BC now McCluskey in, and they're going to pass, and that is complete to Gunnell. That was an ugly-looking one getting out there, but it does show to the 28-yard line. End of the third quarter here. We got a close game here in San Francisco. BC and USC playing a good tune here as they continue to ice skate. Happy holidays in Union Square.
ESPN The Weekend, February 25th through the 28th. Visit ESPNTheWeekend.com for details.
Now during the GMC holiday event, get our best offer of the year, 0% APR for 72 months. Or you can get $5,500 total cash back on select 2009 Sierras in stock.
Could switching to GEICO really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Does Charlie Daniels play a mean fiddle?
That's how you do it, son.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Verizon makes a big deal about their maps, but when you look a little closer, their story begins to fall apart. See, AT&T lets you talk on the phone while you surf the web. Verizon doesn't. AT&T has the most popular smartphones and the nation's fastest 3G network. Verizon doesn't. Glad that's cleared up.
Oh, AT&T, a better 3G experience. This holiday, get a touchscreen Samsung Solstice free after mail-in rebate.
Six overtimes. Can you imagine how you would feel if you missed this game?
Log on to ESPN360.com to see all your favorite sports live. It's where to watch when you can't watch.
It's a sad story, a cautionary tale.
Coming up on SportsCenter, shocking news out of Gainesville as Urban Meyer has decided to step down. USC playing in a non-BCS bowl for the first time in 8 years. And Ron Artest takes a spill. Did the Lakers need him in Sacramento? SportsCenter coming up.
Personalize your holiday shopping with Skinit.com. It's the perfect gift for everyone on your shopping list. Go to Skinit.com today. Create customized holiday gifts online or choose from sports, entertainment, fashion, and more. Go to Skinit.com today.
This is a special announcement. The public is entitled to purchase cars and homes seized by police and bank agents. An inventory of cars and homes are available now and will be sold to the public. Call 800-615-1420. Cars available from $500. Homes available from $199 a month. Down payment assistance available for those who qualify. For listings in your area, call 800-615-1420. That's 800-615-1420. Call 800-615-1420.
2009 Emerald Bowl, part of Capital One Bowl Week. Glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore alongside Rod Gilmore and Todd Harris. BC and USC, two high-priced private schools in major cities, fond of that deep hue of Cardinal Maroon framed against gold. Nothing doing there with Montel Harris. Hey, Todd Harris, what's the deal with Montel?
Well, Joe, the story with Montel Harris, and I'll do it delicately because my mom's listening, is a deep contusion to the right upper gluteus maximus. You guys can infer what that means in our common day vernacular. Also, Everson Griffin for USC hurt his ankle in the first half. We're going to take him at halftime, retape it, see if he can go. Apparently, he cannot go. He is done for the night.
So, Todd, he's got a bum.
Pretty much, yeah. Thanks, Joe.
And he's out here on third and one. They go with James McCluskey, all 250 pounds of him. Shinsky out of the gun. He has time, and he has a man, but it is incomplete. Dropped by Justin Jarvis.
It looked like Jarvis didn't see it. Did it get up on him or something? Because all of a sudden, it looked like it just went by him.
So Shinsky trots off the field after the incompletion. And Ryan Quigley on to punt from the 19. Damian Williams, one of the most dangerous return men in college football, back at the 40. Williams taken down immediately again. USC up by four here. Good special teams tackle by Jim Noel. It's been a really strange year of obstacles to overcome for BC. Jeff Jagosinski was fired in January, and then AD Gene DeFilippo rewarded the loyalty and promoted Frank Spaziani. Then in May, the news that choked up everyone, Mark Herzlich discloses that he has cancer. Dominic Davis, the starting quarterback, left school. Dave Shinsky came in, and then he broke a rib rod that set them back. Running back Josh Hayden left the team, as did quarterback Justin Tuggle, and yet they overcame all that to get to this spot here in the Emerald Bowl. Barkley, incomplete, threw it into the ground. He was looking for Havili.
You think about what Frank Spaziani had to overcome. I mean, the third coach in 4 years, and he arrives with no quarterback with any experience whatsoever. No one who had taken a snap. And then he lost his linebackers as well.
The core of this team is still a team that had done nothing but win in recent years with the bowl win streak. A team that 2 years ago in Boston College got up to number two in the country with Matt Ryan at quarterback. But the program this offseason was nearly gutted. And yet here they are. And now here is Allen Bradford, a good run. Bradford has had himself a nice night. 8 yards there. 63 yards on the night, excuse me. Wes Davis took him down.
And Wes Davis makes a shoestring tackle. He doesn't do that. Allen Bradford is still running.
Well, Allen Bradford working well with quarterback Matt Barkley back in high school. He was a blitzing linebacker against Barkley and broke Barkley's collarbone.
Think he reminds him of that every now and then?
Third and two. BC brings pressure. Barkley lofts it up, and it is incomplete. He was trying to get it to his tight end, Rhett Ellison, but the defensive backs closed on it. The pressure came up the middle by Mike McLaughlin.
And Boston College rarely brings pressure like this. They brought it right up the middle. There you see the pressure by McLaughlin, 34, in the face. And that ball's right there with Ellison. Ellison can't come up with it. He's in for Anthony McCoy.
Anthony McCoy, the starting tight end, who is academically ineligible this week. He is set to be a high NFL draft pick, but the Trojans don't have him tonight. Gunnell with a fair catch. So 13:09 to go. BC only down four. The Emerald Bowl trophy is set to be handed out.
Hey, Diamond walnuts. Anything else is just nuts.
Just sign on and drive off. Mazda's drive-off event is back. Save huge on Mazda CX-7, Mazda 6, Mazda CX-9, and now lease the Mazda 3 with zero down payment, zero first month's payment, zero security deposit, and just $239 a month for 42 months. Hurry to Mazda's year-end drive-off event. Right now, lease the 2010 Mazda 3i Sport with zero first month's payment, zero due at lease signing, and just $239 a month for 42 months.
What are you looking for?
A hairbrush for a Rapunzel Barbie doll.
Oh.
Holiday savings are still happening at Walmart. Starting this Saturday, come to Walmart's Garden Center and get 50% off Christmas items. Save money, live better. Walmart.
They're running the Men's Room Marathon.
With lots of guys going over and over.
And here's the dash to the Men's Room with lots of guys going urgently.
And then there's the night game.
Waking up to go.
These guys should be in a race to see their doctors.
Right. Those could be urinary symptoms due to BPH, an enlarged prostate.
But for many guys, prescription Flomax reduces their urinary symptoms due to BPH in 1 week.
Only your doctor can tell if you have BPH, not a more serious condition like prostate cancer.
When taking Flomax, avoid driving or hazardous tasks until you know how Flomax will affect you, as a sudden drop in blood pressure may occur, rarely resulting in fainting.
Tell your doctor about all medications you take. If considering cataract surgery, tell your eye surgeon you've taken Flomax.
Common side effects are runny nose, dizziness, and decrease in semen.
Ask your doctor if Flomax is right for you.
Call 877-4-FLOMAX to see if you qualify for up to $40 off new or refill prescriptions.
For many men, Flomax can make a difference in 1 week.
This College Football Bowl update is brought to you by Flomax. In the All-State Sugar Bowl on New Year's night will be the final game as the head coach of the Florida Gators for Urban Meyer. Meyer announcing on Saturday that he's stepping down after five glorious seasons in which he won two Southeastern Conference and two national championships with Florida. He's won 95 games over his 9 years as a head coach, including stops at Bowling Green and Utah. Urban Meyer stepping down as head coach of the Gators. Back to Joe and Ryan.
Reese, stunning news tonight. Reese and the guys in the studio have done an outstanding job of covering the breaking news of Urban Meyer all night long. And we've had a good ball game here in San Francisco. Glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore, Rod Gilmore, and Todd Harris. 13:09 to go. USC with a 4-point lead. Matt Barkley keeping warm on the sideline. And now it's the other freshman quarterback, the 25-year-old freshman quarterback, Dave Shinsky, back out on the field. Shinsky has time, complete to Gunnell. First down for the Eagles. Monday Night Football this week. Vikings and Bears. Brett Favre and Adrian Peterson going up against Jay Cutler. Monday Night Football, 8:30 Eastern. It begins with Monday Night Countdown served by Applebee's at 7 Eastern.
Now, Tess, Boston College only has 19 yards of offense in the third quarter.
Shinsky went the other way. He had that great second quarter, but they could not move the ball in the third. Montel Harris is back in there after being injured late in the third. And now Shinsky just chooses to sail it out of bounds over the head of Colin Larmon Jr.
Well, they need more out of Shinsky because Montel Harris is struggling a bit with that bum.
That's right.
You mentioned
he had a contusion to the upper part of the backside, and he was such a big part of this offense. Rich Gunnell, of course, a big target for the Eagles. If Shinsky does choose to go vertical, he had the 61-yard touchdown pass earlier tonight. Second and 10 out of the gun for Shinsky. Looking for Larmond. Sails out of bounds. Yeah, Kevin Thomas with the coverage.
But they're struggling to find something that will work for them. 73 yards rushing for Boston College. You see 180 passing.
They got total a lot yards of there, Rod. I mean, USC had a dominating first quarter. BC really had a dominating second quarter, and that turned off the offense in the third.
It's been one quarter for College.
One quarter represents their production. Third and 10 now. McCluskey flanking Shinsky in the gun. intercepted. Sharice Wright, back to business. Out all year, but here he is coming up big in the fourth when the Trojans needed him.
Oshinsky throws into coverage. He expects man-to-man coverage because he sees the corners up close. You see, he sees that. He thinks it's man coverage. It's not. Watch Wright fall off and play zone coverage. And now he's just reading the inside route coming his way because he's sitting in coverage, makes the play. That's a fantastic play by Wright out there in corner and misleading a young quarterback.
What did Pete Carroll say about I want them to close the game? Now's the time. Barkley airs it out, looking for it all. Williams. How about that? Right on cue. Now that's how you close something out. You take a dagger and you get right after it.
Well, how did he come up with that ball? You have three Boston College defenders there, and Williams goes up at the highest point to take the ball away. Watch him go after this. Three guys there, but the one guy in dark jersey comes up with it.
Damian Williams.
That's Bowman.
What a night for Williams. 11 catches, 166 yards. Barkley now. Straight ahead. Touchdown, Trojans. Just like that, Oshinsky makes the mistake. Pete Carroll goes for it. Williams hauls it in. Barkley caps it off.
A great catch by Williams. And Barkley with a nice throw. You see enough out of him to just know next year he's really going to step up.
Congdon with the extra point and an 11-point cushion now for USC. It all started with Sharice Wright, and he says, Coach, thanks for having faith in me. Here's the ball. Now go do something with it. And did they ever. Damian Williams right down to the goal line.
Okay, 0-3 pickup, average miles, well-maintained. So what do you think?
I think I'll go with the preferred package.
Good choice.
Oh. Only Meineke gives you options on complete car care, and we'll help you choose what's right for you, your car, and your budget. At Meineke, you're always the driver.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Just sign on and drive off. Mazda's drive-off event is back. Save huge on Mazda CX-7, Mazda 3, Mazda CX-9, and now lease the Mazda 6 with zero down payment, zero first month payment, zero security deposit, and just $269 a month for 42 months. Hurry to Mazda's year-end drive-off event. Right now, lease the 2010 Mazda 6i Sport with zero first month payment, zero due at lease signing, and just $269 a month for 42 months.
No time to play. I'm picking a photo for my Capital One credit card. Old man Sutter? Why would I put his picture on my card? Nice drawing, but this photo's cuter.
Personalize your card by uploading your own photo at CapitalOne.com.
Lady, what's in your wallet?
911, what's your emergency?
If you ever make international calls, only Vonage gives you unlimited calling in the U.S. and around the world for just $24.99. Introducing Vonage World. Call 877-4-VONAGE today. Then call India, all of India, or Brazil, all of Brazil. In fact, call all corners of over 60 countries free. And now, sign up by December 31st and get 1 month free. Don't wait. Call 877-4-VONAGE or go to Vonage.com and start saving.
ESPN College Football, the Emerald Bowl, is brought to you by Mazda's Drive-Off Event, where you can sign off on the best deals and drives of the year. Capital One, what's in your wallet? And Vonage. Call 877-4VONAGE now for unlimited calls around the world. Vonage sounds good.
Nothing like a great meal in Chinatown in San Francisco, and that's what our hardworking crew did for Christmas dinner last night. 30 of them away from their families for the holidays, working so hard. Here's the word, Rod. The orange beef was outstanding.
The orange beef. Yeah, I understand they had a lot of choices, though.
Yeah, they took down a lot of platters there, too.
It's been a good week, city by the bay.
USC and Boston College have thoroughly enjoyed their visit to the Emerald Bowl. We're enjoying the action they've put forth here tonight, the squib kick in the wet conditions. And that is corralled at the 30-yard line. Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN tomorrow. Kentucky and Clemson going at it in the Gaylord Hotel's Music City Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN. Also on ESPN360.com tomorrow night at 8:30 Eastern. C.J. Spiller going to be in action. Yeah. He's done it every way, Ron. He's had a kickoff return for a touchdown, a punt return for a touchdown. He's passed for a touchdown, receiving, rushing, every which way he's done it this year.
20 touchdowns on the season. Do you know he averages a touchdown every 7 times he touches the football?
Give him the ball every time then.
Yeah.
Works out well. A little bit of math back in the day. So BC down 11 after the big strike to Williams set up the Barkley touchdown. And now Montel Harris still on his feet, spinning and out to the 39. He has not been at 100% for a good part of this second half. They tried to lean on him. He was injured earlier, now back in the ballgame for Frank Spaziani.
You see, he's trying to fight through the pain of the bruise he has on his backside and provide some offense. Now, they've been relying on Shinsky to throw, but they've tried to protect Shinsky by having him throw outside and deep to the sidelines. When he went across the middle, he got picked off.
Now to pass here. And Shinsky simply runs for the first down and does not slide. Instead, goes forward and meets up with Chris Galippo.
Yeah, we talked about how USC's defense was hurt by teams that could run the quarterback. That's not anything that Boston College does very well, which is why they've used Wildcat, you know, tonight to try and create that. Oregon, they're in Wildcat every play with Jeremiah Masili at quarterback.
Pete Carroll, of course, this defense. You know, last week there were 4 rookie linebackers in the NFL starting who were on USC's roster last year.
Yeah.
USC could only start 3 linebackers. There were 4 of them starting in the NFL last week as rookies. And now more straight ahead running by Montel Harris, a gain of 9. Well, you got to play through the pain, and that's what Harris is doing here in the fourth quarter. And regardless of the time, down 11, this is BC's best approach to offense, feeding Montel Harris. Coach Spaz. Second bowl game he's been a head coach of. He was an interim coach when they won the Meineke Car Care Bowl back in 06. And Harris pushing forward for the first down.
This is a drive to show some patience and to get back into the ball game and not to panic by throwing every down. They need a score.
Frank Spaziani knows something about patience. 13 years as an assistant coach, all the years as a defensive coordinator all over college football and in the CFL, and finally landing his first head coaching job.
Well, how about a couple years ago, when Jags was hired and he was passed over? I mean, that looked like the last opportunity for him to become a head coach.
And then athletic director Gene DeFilippo justifying the loyalty pick. And it's worked out. And here Shinsky just tries to make the most of it, getting it to James McCluskey. Chris Galippo with his 3rd tackle of the game.
Now, again, you need points out of this drive. It's a 2-possession game right now. Even if you stall out and you get a field goal out of this thing, it puts more pressure on USC. You make it a 1-possession game. So they have to find a way to come up with enough yardage to at least get a field goal out of this drive.
They try to pick and choose what they can do with the passing game. But at some point, you just have to go in that direction. Pressure from behind. Unable to get away at all. Jarrell Casey just swarms down and gets to Dave Shinsky.
Casey's having himself a night. He had that fumble recovery and run from inside the 10-yard line earlier in the ball game. And then this time, he just gets around the outside and makes a nice move to get to the quarterback.
Casey's got a sack, a tackle for a loss, and a fumble recovery tonight. First sack of the game. Third and 14 now. Pressure straight up the middle. Out of bounds. Good play by Kevin Thomas on the coverage of Clyde Lee, but he couldn't stay in. It'll bring up a fourth down.
Yeah, that sack took them out of field goal range, any possibility of it, and they had a desperate throw there. And now you have to really think in terms of really, you got to have a stop here. If you're Boston College, you've got to have a stop after this exchange of punts.
Shinsky over on the sidelines breathing hard, and you just look at that jersey. He's got part of that Emerald Bowl logo painted upon it at this point. Quigley back onto punt. A lone directional punt that takes a roll inside the 20. Dave Shinsky searching for answers here in the fourth quarter against this Trojans defense. Stay with us. More from San Francisco to come.
ESPN Monday Night Football, Vikings Bears at 8:30.
What were you thinking?
It was after three. Your blood sugar was low. Have some Emerald Nuts. They'll keep you sharp.
Manage the 3 p.m. slump with the natural energy of Emerald Nuts.
We started with over 1 billion colors. Generously added more than 2 million liquid crystal pixels. Combine 960 backlighting LEDs with 240 flawless scenes per second. Made it 50% more energy efficient. And it all came down to one thing. The new 55-inch True LED from Vizio. Superior picture performance, superior price from America's number one LCD HD TV company.
When the flu hits you hard, hit right back with Theraflu. Nothing fights your worst flu symptoms with more power. Theraflu, good to be back.
Are nasty drafts forcing you to crank up the heat? Heating bills are reported to increase dramatically, causing your money to literally fly out the door. With Twin Draft Guard's double-sided insulated design, your utility bills can be reduced by up to 30%. Watch. Air seeps under the door, but Twin Draft Guard creates an airtight seal. It's adjustable, slides under any door or window. Cut the length you need. Cover and slide onto the door for a draft-proof seal. Twin Draft Guard seals any gap on any floor, even carpet. Use on windows for an airtight seal. Block wind and snow. Insulate garage and basements. Seal in air conditioning. Twin Draft Guard is only $19.99. Call now and we'll double the offer. If it doesn't pay for itself the very first month, send it back for a refund. As a free gift, get the over-the-door ceramic hook. Absolutely free. You get it all. Just $19.99.
Call 1-800-659-6940. Order now and you'll get two double-sided Twin Draft Guards and the free over-the-door hanger for $19.99. Call 1-800-659-6940 or go to twindraftguard.com.
USC up 24-13 here in the fourth quarter of the Emerald Bowl. Tonight's game track is brought to you by EAS, and it started with a heavy dose of the fullback Stanley Havili out of the backfield, Rob.
Yeah, Matt Barkley started hot. Havili started hot. Gunnell made the big play of the first half for Boston College on this long touchdown run after the catch. And then Barkley with a big play to Damian Williams that set up Barkley's sneak in for a touchdown. A catch made with three Boston College defenders draped around him.
That was after an interception, and Damian Williams has 11 catches for 166 yards. C.J. Gable now. And Gable is stopped right away by Brad Newman.
And this is a huge second down for Boston College. They have to get a stop, create a third and long situation so that they can get the ball back in good field position, shorten that field, and get a score, any kind of a score, to make it a one possession game.
Their defense has played very spirited for their former defensive coordinator, Coach Spaz, tonight. They gave up the big play to Williams, but they've given their offense opportunity. Dave Shinsky, the quarterback, hasn't been able to deliver in the second half. Barkley now. He has it complete. And once again, and crossing over to the 36, is Damian Williams. Oh, what a night for Williams. Another 23 yards tacked on. He has a 189 on 12 receptions.
But that was Barkley. Barkley made that happen. He looked off. He was going to go to the outside and then waited. He waited for Williams to come back and clear and get open over the middle and gave it to him. But that's just a great job by a young quarterback who now sees and feels things much better than he did a few weeks ago.
Barkley had a very good first quarter tonight, and now he's having a very good fourth quarter, bookending things. And look at this. Bowman just comes in with such intensity. That's what he's known for, Marcellus Bowman. Probably the hardest hitter in the ACC. He's a nasty player.
This is one of the few blitzes we've seen out of Boston College, and he comes in clean. No way for them to pick him up because they used a linebacker to occupy the rest of the side of that line there, and he's just made a fantastic play. What a night for him. A forced fumble. He has a pick, five tackles, and a tackle for a loss.
That's the only sack BC's had of Barkley tonight. Under 6 minutes. USC trying to close out this game. C.J. Gable fighting for more. And Gable's out to the 34. Gable is a junior running back. He's got a lot of time throughout his career, but this year, Joe McKnight, of course, stealing the show among the running backs. Coming up after this game will be SportsCenter. Plenty of bull action today, and of course, the big story in sports, Urban Meyer.
Yeah.
Plans to step down at Florida.
I just hope he's okay. I mean, the timing of that makes you worry about his health for himself and for his family, for him to make that decision unexpectedly like that.
They get it out quickly to Butler. And Gauze with his ninth tackle of the game.
Think about what has happened in Florida the last few years with Urban Meyer, what he's done there, having Tim Tebow there. They have been dominant in college football, a 56-10 record, five bowl appearances, two national championships, coach of the year in 2004. You could have named him coach of the year another time after that. He's been the central figure in coaching in college football for the last five, 6 years.
Well, it'll be interesting to see what happens in the course of the next week, because obviously the news of Meyer brings about the speculation now.
Sure.
As to who will take over one of the truly elite programs in all of college football. And one of the names we've been hearing as people react to it is the guy who was just there a year and a half ago as their coordinator, Dan Mullen, who's now at Mississippi State.
You'll hear about
that. What do you
that?
Make of that, Rod?
I think it's going to happen. I think you'll hear that talk. I think you'll also hear Charlie Strong's name come up because he just left to Louisville. So I think you'll hear those names. You'll probably even hear guys who've been in Florida before, you know, like Bob Stoops. His name always comes up.
You know, it's one of those jobs where somebody would be willing to leave another major program to consider it. Punt takes a USC bounce and settles in at the 21. So there will be 4:42 to go, and BC's offense will come back out for one last chance to try to close this gap.
Sir, how did this happen?
You know, Dr. Burke,
Sometimes I feel like burning this whole place down.
Great. That sounds like real progress.
It was after three. Your blood sugar was low. Eat some Emerald Nuts. They'll keep you focused.
Banish the 3 p.m. slump with the natural energy of Emerald Nuts.
Just sign on and drive off. Mazda's drive-off event is back. And you won't believe how easy it is to get into a Mazda right now. To find out, log on to MazdaUSA.com.
It was a horrible feeling, like I couldn't catch my breath. I couldn't believe I was actually having a heart attack. I remember being at the hospital, thinking about my wife. I should have done more to take care of myself. Now I'm exercising, watching my diet, and I trust my heart to Lipitor.
Unlike some other cholesterol-lowering medications, Lipitor is FDA-approved to reduce the risk of heart attack, stroke, and certain kinds of heart surgeries in patients with several common risk factors or heart disease. Lipitor is backed by over 17 years of research. Lipitor is not for everyone, including people with liver problems and women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant. You need simple blood tests to check for liver problems. Tell your doctor if you are taking other medications or if you have any muscle pain or weakness. This may be a sign of a rare but serious side effect.
I'll never forget what I went through. Don't take your health for granted.
Have a heart-to-heart with your doctor about your risk and about Lipitor.
To pursue the life you want, you need a financial advocate who knows where you want to go. A Merrill Lynch financial advisor, now with access to the resources of Bank of America, can help you diversify, rebalance, imagine, and believe. Merrill Lynch Wealth Management.
To drive off, just sign off. Mazda's drive-off event. Right now, lease the 2010 Mazda 6i Sport with zero first month's payment, zero due at lease signing, and just $269 a month for 42 months.
Rob, there's my main man right there in the trolley in downtown San Francisco. That's not a cable car. That's a trolley. Thing's got wheels. I don't know. How do you feel about that?
I prefer the cable car. Cable car for me.
I'm with you on that. Coming up after our game here, as we look at the Golden Gate Bridge, we've got Sports Center coming up, and then ESPN News. We'll have our post-game extra, give you our analysis of USC NBC, and then over on ESPN360.com, you can log in and watch live coverage of the post-game trophy ceremony here at the Emerald Bowl. See who's the offensive and defensive MVP.
Tess, they should log on right now. I've logged on ESPN.com 360. I got that up now.
You and your smartphone, inseparable. Shinsky being chased, now keeps it on the ground and slides in smartly for a gain of eight. Clock will continue to run here. USC able to bring this margin to 11 when Damian Williams hauled in the 48-yard catch down to the one, then Barkley punched it in.
And that series was the backbreaker.
Well, the Sharice Wright interception. Yep. Shinsky made the bad mistake at midfield, and then right away, USC came right after them and pushed this thing to 24-13. It was a close and competitive game throughout until that point. Now, BC trying one last time here to get back into it. That ball was batted by Jarrell Casey. Jarrell Casey is having a monster game.
He's made every kind of play. He's had that fumble recovery, showed some athleticism, then a nice little spin to get away. Also has a sack tonight. He's got a tackle for a loss, a pass breakup.
You know, I look at him there. He stretches out that uniform, gets it all dirty. He's got that body. He goes 6'1", 300. You know what his nickname is? Meatball.
Are you kidding me?
Great
Meatball.
Nickname for a defensive tackle. Meatball Casey.
I bet they didn't call him that at Long Beach Poly. He was the big man on campus.
Third and two now for Shinsky. And a first down for BC as Pantelli was able to hold on to that ball. And Will Harris came hard charging for his sixth tackle of the night. Well, it's not a BCS trophy or a Rose Bowl trophy that USC has become accustomed to, but 350 and counting away from securing the Emerald Bowl. Matt Barkley's first bowl game of what could be an outstanding college career. That is incomplete. And one of the crew members there just run over that time by Michael Morgan.
You know, Shinsky has thrown a lot of passes toward the sidelines. And that's typical with young quarterbacks. You try to keep them away from the middle of the field, where they're the linebackers and safeties, a lot of guys, and bad things can happen. We saw one of those earlier. This one, watch the end of this play here.
So you want to work on a chain gang and be up close to the action?
That's a face full right there.
Pressure comes on Shinsky. Releases it and gets it to Gunnell. Gunnell with a nice move, and Rich Gunnell out to the USC 48-yard line, a gain of 16. Rich Gunnell has had a very good career. The senior here playing in his final game for BC, the all-time leading receiver in terms of yardage in the history of the Eagles.
Shinsky standing in against pressure. And you mentioned Gunnell. He really kind of came on the scene when Matt Ryan was at Boston College. Kind of became his favorite target as he had a great season. And he has not disappointed tonight with his performance in what looks like his final ball game.
He's a smart player, does not have great speed, but is precise, has tremendous ball skills.
Did you see him run away from the USC secondary?
That's funny, because that's always been the scouting report on him, and it's what we always say in discussing him, but yet when the ball's in his hand, he has great speed.
He ran away from the secondary.
It's just not how he plays the receiver position. It's a good route run. The thunder came in the form of Nick Perry, a defensive end who rotates in, bringing down Dave Shinsky.
That's his eighth sack as a backup player, freshman All-American, Nick Perry. Think Pete Carroll isn't motivated and into this thing?
That was almost comical in the course of the past couple weeks of hearing everybody talking about, oh, USC would be disinterested. Where will be the enthusiasm and the motivation to play in this game against this opponent? We went to practice. You talked to Pete Carroll. When has that ever been an issue with USC?
Yeah, we've heard that over the years. Oh, they don't want to play in another Rose Bowl game. They'd show up and they'd pound their opponent.
Exactly.
And you go out and you watch them practice like we did this week. You knew they'd be coming. Now, the Pac-10 has been struggling this season because, you know, Cal lost, Oregon State lost, and now USC is starting to right the ship. But a lot of games left. Hard to tell how the conference is going to fare with that matchup. Ohio State, Oregon, Pac-10 has dominated the Rose Bowl for a long time now. Ohio State trying to change that history.
Third and 17. Gunnell. That gets it to the 45, so it'll make for a fourth down. And a timeout is called for Boston College with 3:01 remaining. Coach Spaz wants to gather the troops and discuss this fourth down. Gives us an opportunity to tell you tonight's player of the game, brought to you by Capital One.
Yeah, Damian Williams, 12 receptions, 189 yards, and had really the play of the game. Think about what he did tonight. Look at this game. Watch him make guys miss after catching the ball. Once again, out in the open, making things happen, making guys miss. But the real play of the game was this one. After the pick by Sharice Wright, he comes right back, very next play, makes a grab with three guys around him. That set up what would be the clinching touchdown, it appears, by Matt Barkley.
This was a 17-13 game. It was highly competitive, well fought, and then that, which is potentially the play that seals it for USC, unless Dave Shinsky has a miracle in him. Fourth down. Lofts it up. Wow! What an effort by Gunnell, but he couldn't hold on.
Hey, what hasn't he shown?
He tried his best, didn't he?
Oh, are you kidding me? He almost came up with this thing one-handed, the ball thrown way over his head, somewhat behind him, and he still almost comes up. Watch him here in the slot here.
Watch where this ball is. High and behind him, and he almost comes up with it.
Rod, if that ends up being the last play in the college career of Rich Gunnell, you know what? It's probably fitting because he was always all effort. BC's all-time leading receiver in terms of yardage. Tonight, he had another big game going for 130 yards. Just not enough to get up on that ladder and bring it down.
No reason for him to hang his head about his performance tonight or his career or the way this Boston College team performed this season.
Bradford now as USC will try to bring down that clock. And as they do, we remind you that Sports Center will be coming up after the game. Steve Levy, John Anderson, and the big one everybody's going to be talking about, Urban Meyer and his decision to step down as the head coach at the University of Florida.
Just a stunning decision as it made its way around the stadium here.
What a buzz there was pregame. When that news came in, I know our Todd Harris talked to Pete Carroll, and he was just getting word and reacting to it himself. And will that cause a domino effect in college football in the coaching ranks?
False start, offense, number 76, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
USC trying to close in on another bowl win. Currently tied with Alabama for the most bowl victories, but this would be number 32. Of course, Bama could get themselves a bowl victory in a couple weeks. That would be awfully sweet in that BCS national title game. Bradford now as Luke Kuechly comes up with yet another tackle, his 13th of the game. The freshman linebacker, the second in the nation in tackles. Among the major conferences, he averaged 11.8 per game. A staggering average of tackles, and the sky's the limit for Keek.
Well, just wait. He'll have a spring practice. He'll have a little bit more weight on it. He had a great year without fully understanding what he had to do as a linebacker.
And now an end around, and they go with Patterson. And Patterson able to get the first down. And USC has it inside the 40. This is just a minute 19 remaining. Pete Carroll back in his hometown area. He was born in San Francisco, grew up in Marin County. And come the new year, he'll be heading to Hawaii. You don't see Ohio State there. You get a non-conference of Hawaii, Virginia, Minnesota, Notre Dame at the end of the year. And what will the future bring in 2010 for the Trojans?
That's a team that will have a veteran defense, a veteran quarterback, and another strong recruiting class. I think if Pete Carroll is about anything, he is about competition. He's about competing. And folks who didn't realize that his team would be focused and into this ball game didn't understand that Pete Carroll demands that his team compete.
They always compete, don't they? This year, some spots of inconsistent play at quarterback, a lack of experience at defense, and that's why you saw some of the results in the tough Pac-10 at Oregon, the game against Stanford, the disappointment against Arizona. But the time off served them well. They regrouped. Matt Barkley refocused, freshened up after the grind of a full season as a true freshman. And he came out tonight and threw for 350 yards, 189 of that going to the star receiver, Damian Williams. BC came to play. They hung tough for three quarters. But in the end, the men of Troy, the victors again.
Well, Tess, it was really about a play in the fourth quarter. It was about the turnover, Sharice Wright getting the pick off of Shinsky, and USC coming right back with Barkley and Williams to make a big play.
Our Todd Harris is standing by with Matt Barkley. Todd.
Well, Matt, your freshman year comes to a conclusion in San Francisco, started with Hawaii. What has this year meant to you?
It's huge, and it's been a crazy year, and you know, we've had some ups and we've had some downs, but to be able to finish like this and with this victory, especially for the seniors, it's huge. And this is what we came here, this is what we wanted to do, and you know, it turned out well for us. So I'm so happy with how our guys played tonight. It's really a really good feeling right now.
Coach Carroll's gonna let you celebrate for a little while, but he's gonna get right back to the drawing board. What does this team need to do to get better next year?
Just welcome the guys that are coming early. We've got a couple guys coming in early, but just improve on a lot of things. And you know, this whole season has helped me a lot, knowing how to help those younger guys and even how to be a leader to the older guys. So, but this win right here really sends us on a good note into that off season, and will help us a lot with that. So,
thanks, Matt. Congratulations.
Thank you, guys.
Joe.
Thanks, Todd. Rod could be the start of good things to come in the career of Matt Barkley when it comes to postseason victories.
He's a talented quarterback, and he learned a lot this year. Great experience. You can just see him grow. Even during this ball game, he's going to be outstanding.
Final score, Trojans win it 24-13. 32 bowl victories now, the most of any school. It's been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Rod Gilmore, Todd Harris, and our entire crew, I'm Joe Tessitore. So long from San Francisco. Now, let's